It couldn't get any more exciting than this. Two magnificent hockey teams playing at a skill level and a tempo I don't think we have ever seen before in hockey. Mike Keenan, the coach of Canada, what do you expect to see happen tonight?
I think you just said it the best. It's an all-out effort by two teams that are great teams. They're going to put everything on the line and take it to the limit. And it's going to be a fabulous sight for all of us to watch.
Mike, best luck to you and the rest of Team Canada.
Thanks very much, Dan.
Now let's go to Brad Park.
I'm at ice level with Igor Dmitriev, the assistant coach and main spokesman for the Soviet team. Your team has played two great games, but you're going to have two or three players come through tonight. And who will they be?
Five. Krutov, Makarov, Fetisov, Kasatonov, and Larionov.
Thank you very much, Igor, and good luck. We'll be with Ron Reusch and Dan Kelly in a moment, so stay tuned as it's going to be a great night in Hamilton.
Game one, Friday night in Montreal in overtime. Alexander Semak wins it for the Soviet Union. Game two in Hamilton Sunday night. Wayne Gretzky beats Mario Lemieux. And in double overtime, Canada wins to tie the series. Welcome to the Copps Coliseum in Hamilton, Ontario, and the Labatt Canada Cup 1987. The final game tonight, the Soviet Union and Canada. Hello again, everyone. Welcome to Hamilton. I don't know what more you can say about these two teams, except I'll say one thing. Tonight, somebody will win this game, win this series, but there will not be a loser. I have just witnessed two of the greatest hockey games I've ever watched, and I'm sure a lot of you have watched along with me and agree. Tonight, whoever wins will be a winner, of course, but the loser will not be a loser. They've both been winners. It's been unbelievable hockey. Ron Reusch, I don't know what they'll do to play game three, but after game one and two, expect anything.
Well, expect anything. I know one thing that the two coaches downstairs have told me. Both clubs are just walking on air in the dressing room. Mike Keaton had to chase his hockey club off the ice during practice this morning. As for tactics, well, the Soviets have been ganging Grant Fuhr a lot, more than Fuhr has ever seen with a Soviet team. And as for Canada, they're going to have to depend on their 2-on-2s because the Soviets have been effective there.
It should be another classic. Stay with us.
Friday night in Montreal, I thought I'd witnessed the best hockey game I'd ever seen, and I had until Sunday night in Hamilton.
Like a movable feast, isn't it, Dan? Now here it is, Tuesday night in Hamilton, and we just may see another one. We have played two games in the playoff round, one game in the primary or preliminary round. The whole situation is one tie hockey game, two others that were tied and ended up in overtime. So who can say who's the best team out there?
The intensity, the speed, the emotion. I've never seen hockey played with the skill level throwing those three ingredients into.
You know, you tend to get lost in the fact that they're so evenly balanced. Listen to the crowd as Team Canada hits the ice here at Copps Coliseum in Hamilton. You tend to get lost in the fact that these two teams are so evenly matched, that the speed level, the high intensity of the game. You say, oh, why didn't that guy make that play? How could he miss it? When so, the checking, they're getting on you so quick, there's just no time to think, or even that split second isn't there to make a play anymore. So they have just taken the game to a new all-time high here in Hamilton and here in the finals of the Canada Cup.
There's Don Koharski, the referee for tonight's game. Meanwhile, another terrific reception from a standing room only crowd here in Hamilton for Canada. Listen to this.
Now, Mike Keenan said it was a big, big factor in the game the other night. The standing ovation to start the game paved the way to the best period of hockey that Team Canada has played. The opening period the other night. And then in the second overtime, he says the crowd and everything else just rejuvenated the team the coach of the Soviet Union, Viktor Tikhonov.
Now to the opening ceremonies. As Labatt Breweries and Hockey Canada proudly present this 1987 Labatt Canada Cup. Bonsoir, mesdames, messieurs, bienvenue au Copps Coliseum. C'est avec fierté que la brasserie Labatt et Hockey Canada vous présente la Coupe Canada Labatt 1987. Tonight's game is the third and last of the finals between Team Soviet Union and Team Canada. Le match de ce soir, le troisième et dernier opposant l'équipe de l'Union soviétique et l'équipe Canada. Here are the officials for tonight's game. Voici les officiels pour le match de ce soir. Your referee, l'arbitre. From Canada, Mr. Don Koharski. Licensing the linesman from the Soviet Union, de l'Union Soviétique, Monsieur Mikhail Galinovsky. Et to Canada, from Canada, John D'Amico. Here is the starting lineups for Team Soviet Union. In goes Donny Filet, number one, le numéro un, Sergei Milnikov. À la défense, en défense, number two, le numéro deux, Vyacheslav Fetisov. Number seven, le numéro sept, Alexei Kasatonov. At left wing, à l'aile gauche, number nine, le numéro neuf, Vladimir Krutov. Center, au centre, number 11, le numéro 11, Igor Larionov. À l'aile droite, at right wing, le numéro 24, number 24, Sergei Makarov. The head coach, l'entraîneur chef, Mr. Viktor Tikhonov. L'entraîneur adjoint, the assistant coach, Mr. Igor Dmitriev. And now, the starting lineup for Team Canada. It goes, Donny Filet, number 31, numéro 31, Grant de Fuhr. On defense, à la défense, number two, numéro deux, Doug Crossman. Number 77, numéro 77, Paul Coffey. At right wing, à l'aile droite, number 11, numéro 11, Mark Messier. Left wing, à l'aile gauche, number 66, numéro 66, Mario Lemieux. And at center, au centre, number 99, Wayne Gretzky. The head coach, l'entraîneur chef, Mr. Mike Keenan. The assistant coaches, Monsieur Jean Perron, Mr. John Muckler, and Mr. Tom Watt. As it is the custom in international hockey, the two captains, Vyacheslav Fetisov and Wayne Gretzky, will now exchange gifts on behalf of their teams. Comme c'est la coutume au hockey international, l'échange des cadeaux entre les deux capitaines. Now introducing the members of the official party for tonight's ceremonial face-off. Maintenant, les personnalités qui procéderont à la mise au jeu protocolaire du match de ce soir. Canadian Tire is a proud supporter of sports for people of all ages in communities across Canada, from the Canadian Amateur Hockey Association to the Calgary 1988 Olympic Winter Games. C'est avec fierté que Canadian Tire accorde son appui au sport en général partout au Canada, du hockey mineur jusqu'aux Olympiques d'hiver de Calgary de 1988. Representing the grassroots of hockey,
Representant de hockey mineur, two hockey players, Chris and Michelle Graham. Representing the Olympic world, representant le monde de l'Olympisme, from the Canadian Alpine Ski Team, Miss Lisa Savijavi. Representing Canadian Tire, representant Canadian Tire, the Vice President, Mr. Steve Bolken. Representing the sponsor of the Labatt's Canada Cup, Mr. Rick Torp, Director of Provincial Sales, Labatt's Ontario Limited. Would the captains come to center ice, please, for the face-off? Of both countries by Mr. Michael Burgess. Qui va chanter les hymnes nationaux.
Canada, our home and native land.
is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV. Tonight, the Soviets will go with the veteran 28-year-old Sergei Milnikov. He's 5-0 in this tournament, a 2.36 goals against average. Grant Fuhr has played in all seven previous games for Canada, and he has a 3.15 goals against average and is seemingly unperturbable in there.
As far as the Soviet team is concerned, they've made one major change. They have benched veteran Vasily Perepukhin and Igor Kravchuk, a youngster, 21 years of age, who's been bothered by a knee problem, is in the lineup on defense. Mike Keenan, meanwhile, has Rick Tocchet dressed for tonight's game, and he will play tonight. How much, we don't know. This comes after a quick flight to Philadelphia to have his knee injury checked out. They say he cannot damage the knee further. And so Tocchet is on the bench, and you think he's not ready for tonight's game. And there are the starting lineups. Very predictable. The green unit for the Soviet Union, centered by Larionov. And we'll start the game with Gretzky and Mario Lemieux together, along with Messier on the forward line.
And every time you see Larionov out there, you usually see Messier against him, and that's the way we start. Krutov in across the line for Makarov. Centering pass, Messier back-checking, gives it to Gretzky. Behind the back pass for Lemieux, but it's shot out of there by Fetisov. Now to Larionov. Larionov leaving it for Makarov. He's checked by Lemieux from behind. Now Krutov closing in. Gretzky checked him from behind. And Gretzky winds it around. Center. They score! Makarov all alone in front of the net. Set up by Krutov. And an early goal for the Soviets.
Doug Crossman at the side of the net let the puck come to him rather than going after the puck and found himself beaten to it. Gretzky clearing it around the net. Crossman is number two as Gretzky is decked. Crossman, well, the puck's already in the net, but Crossman had been beaten to the puck. Here's a better view of it. And you can see that Crossman is way out of position. The puck is stripped from him. And Makarov with the goal, and the Soviets lead.
Makarov's seventh of this tournament. So the green unit strikes early, and the Soviets lead. Here's Gretzky shooting it into center ice. Krop couldn't knock it down. And going back to the Soviets, Bumatov. He leaves it there, and here's the new man in the lineup tonight, Igor Kravchuk, clearing it into center ice. Canada's Mario Lemieux dropping it back to Doug Crossman, number two, who fires it out of there. Kravchuk, number 29, just 21 years of age, as a matter of fact, turned 21 today, cleared it in. Canada trying to get it out of there. Soviets hold it in. Here's a drive just wide by Bumatov. And Canada then clear it out of there. But Dotov, number 14, back for the Soviets. Into center to Konyansky, number 13. Sidestep to check. Back comes Howardchuk, flipping it in. And the Dotov is there to clear it away. Bork tried to hold it in, couldn't. Soviets break out of there. In on the left side, Lomakin, number 23, centered it, but it comes all the way back into center ice. Here's Gusarov, number three, flipping it. Bork knocks it down. Bork to Howardchuk. Dropping it back to Larry Murphy, number eight. Murphy slides it in. And the Soviets, Gusarov, checked by Howardchuk. Howardchuk trying to get up to Tocket, but he was upended on the play. And the Soviets fire it out of there with Ramo Bork of the Boston Bruins back to get it for Canada. To Dale Howardchuk, leaving it for Sutter, back to Howardchuk. Scooped in, and Milnikov caught it and held it, and we'll get a face-off. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
What makes the Formula One World Champion such a great race car? Computer-programmed fuel injection. Dual overhead cams. Four valves per cylinder. What makes this such a great street car? Exactly the same technology. The Acura Integra. One of Car and Driver's 10 best, exclusively at your Acura dealer.
Took only 26 seconds. Sergei Makarov from Krutov, who is the one who stripped the puck from Doug Crossman behind the net, and fed it quickly in front. 26 seconds. Soviets leading 1-0.
Now Canada with a line of Doug Gilmore, Mario Lemieux, and Brent Sutter. Zemchinov and Gilmore on the faceoff. Gilmore gets it to Brent Sutter. Header to Lemieux to Gilmore. Shoots and Milnikov went to his knees to rob Gilmore. Canada's best chance thus far. Soviets take possession and fire it out of there. Imelev into center ice, trying to get it ahead for Priyanka. Fiora way out of the net to clear it, and he cleared it up over the glass and into the crowd, and then some bumping on the boards by Humalap and Sutter after the whistle.
Well, Brent Sutter raising a little hop with Don Koharski. Two Stanley Cup winners for Sutter. He won't feel the pressure at all in a game of this moment. Of course, also part of the Canada Cup in 1984 and a big star for Canada in the 84 Canada Cup. Just 25 years of age and seven seasons already in the NHL. Part of a very big family.
I'm sure he has a few brothers across North America watching this one tonight. Let's see, there'd be Dwayne and Daryl in Chicago, Brian in St. Louis. Who am I missing? Rich Neron. Plus mom and dad and the rest of the Sutters from Viking, Alberta. Puck is cleared on the ice. Here's Doug Gilmore chipping it in. Lemieux went in after it, and Chinov tied him up, and now Fetisov loses it. Rochefort couldn't get it, and Kasatonov feeds it into center ice for Imelev. Imelev dropped pass back, and Chinov couldn't control it. Now Priyakin can't center it. Priyakin still after it. Gets it to number 8, Imelev. Back on the point. Shot and by Nenchinov is blocked, and Canada come to center. Gretzky firing it in. Back to get it, Kasatonov. That's Lemieux stealing it, but Nenchinov was there to prat it away. And the Soviets take over, and Fetisov cleared it into center ice. This is Doug Crossman back near his own blue line to Coffey. Back to Crossman. Crossman flips it near the line. Shot right back out by Kravchuk, the newcomer in the Soviet lineup tonight, and that's icing against the Soviets. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Playing hockey was a wonderful experience. Today, young Canadians are carrying on the tradition. Unfortunately, costs have increased. That's why McCormick Champagne Crackers have come to the support of minor hockey. October to December, when the young people come to your door, support them. $1 out of every package sold goes to support local teams, so everyone wins. You can enjoy the great taste of McCormick Champagne Crackers and support a Canadian tradition.
Well, there's the latest energy-saving device.
He applauded so loudly and long the other night, he brought his own applauder tonight. 1-0, the Soviets leading. And Larionov from deep in the Soviet zone. The center, 3-on-2 break, led by Larionov to Makarov. Shoots, you're the save, and he bats that rebound away with his big goal stick. Back comes Canada, Glenn Anderson, number 9. Anderson trying to drop it back, Stelnov intercepts. Right back, he comes the other way to Krutov. And it's Crossman clearing it, Makarov held it in. Now he's slammed into the boards by Messier, and Crossman feeds it over, and Rochefort shot at the center. Back is Stelnov. Off the boards to Larionov. Back to Stelnov. Fired it out. Gartner tried to knock it down. Here's Krutov to Larionov. He's checked in back the other way. Comes Howard Chuck, cutting right in. Wide by about a foot. Big burst of speed by Howard Chuck. And Gusarov has it for the Soviets. He tried to clear it. Bork held it in. Shot deflected and just wide. And Krutov slaps it down the ice to relieve the pressure. That's icing against the Soviets.
Well, Howard Chuck with a very, very big chance. And you notice the march he got on the defenseman. You underrate Howard Chuck's speed a little bit sometimes, but this time he really got loose and he just beat the defenseman to the net and then just shot it a bit wide. Stole the puck at center ice. The defenseman now is turned around on the play. That's Stelnov there, and now he's got a big jump on him. And Howard Chuck probably had a little bit of room to get around the defenseman and get directly in front of the goal, but he thought he was going to be under a little more pressure than he in fact was. Shot quicker than he wanted to and missed by about 5 inches.
Mike Keenan must feel Howard Chuck is hot. He leaves him out there with Gretzky and Lemieux. And the Soviets clear it to center ice. Bork back to get it to Gretzky. Over to Howard Chuck. Into Lemieux, who gets pulled down by Fetisov. And Fetisov will get the game's first penalty. And Canada will have a power play. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Discover a new species, 1988 Chevrolet Beretta, for the way you drive today.
Today's Chevrolet
Beretta.
Going your way.
Bekov is off for interference at 4:59. When you take a scoring chance away, it has to be called. And there you see it right at the bottom of your screen. Mario Lemieux would have been free. A chance unfolding for Canada. Bekov just hauled his man down. The penalty had to be called.
Here's Copps to Gretzky. Canada with the man advantage. Back to Copps. Over onto the other point. Bork centered. It was too hard for Gretzky to knock down. And now the puck comes back into Canada's zone with Copps back to gut it. To Mark Messier. Leaving it there. And here is Bork to Copps to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux trying to get it to Bork. Comes to Gretzky. Gretzky in the slot. Centered, oh, and Messier just failed to tip it in. Now behind the net to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux, number 66, to Gretzky. Back to Copps. Into Lemieux, but intercepted by Kasatonov. And the Soviets shorthanded come to center ice. Kasatonov doing a good job. Cleared it in, and Bork is back to get it. 1:08 left in the Soviets' penalty. Bork to Copps. Soviets have scored a shorthanded goal in each of the three games against Canada, so keep that in mind. They shoot it in. Fetisov back to get it, firing it out of there. And Bork will have to chase back. 50 seconds left in the penalty. Bork just slaps it in. And Milnikov out of the goal, handed it right to Anderson. Now to Gretzky. Gretzky cutting in, trying to center. Stelnov broke it up. Now Gretzky out in front. In front, Goulet shot, rebound. Blocked out by Anderson, and Milnikov got a piece of that. And it's cleared away. Again, the puck artistry and the playmaking of Gretzky. Here is Copps. Into Gretzky. Trying to hit Goulet in the slot. Soviets clear it, knocked down by Hartsburg. To Gretzky. In front, Goulet upended in the slot. And Gusarov gets out of there. 2-on-1, Soviet break. Copps trying to get back. Here's the shot, off the goalpost. Oh, and Gusarov, now they put the red light on.
I think it went in the net.
Gusarov indicated he had scored, but the red light did not come on. Then it did. And let's see what Koharski rules here.
They're signaling the face-off at center ice. I thought it went in the net and came out. But the light did not go on, and then it came on very briefly and went out again. Koharski has signaled there's a goal, and we've got a, well, let's take a look at it here now.
Off the post,
right there, right inside the net. So it went all the way around and came back out. So you're right, it did hit a post, but then rattled around inside the cage before coming out.
2-0, the Soviets lead. Here's James Patrick trying to feed it to Doug Gilmore. Poked away by Milnikov, Sutter in to get it, and now Prigogine, number 22, into center to Nemchinov, number 12. And that's offside at the blue line. Kumalev in ahead of the play. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Professor, I found something.
A primitive hammer. Excellent condition.
When man makes something well, it lasts a long, long time.
Find something?
Did you drop your hammer here?
Not me. It's probably Joe. He's always dropping things.
Mastercraft hand tools from Canadian Tire. They're guaranteed forever.
This program is protected by copyright. Any use of this telecast without permission is prohibited. 2-0, the Soviets lead. That last scoring play, Gusarov unassisted at 7:04. Just after the Soviet player, 5 seconds after he had come back onto the ice from serving a penalty, so it wasn't a shorthanded goal. But an early jump for the Soviets, a 2-0 lead. Here's Fetisov clearing it into center ice. Messier knocks it down. Got it into the corner. Fetisov now to Makarov, to Larionov. Larionov leaving it for Krutov. He's checked by Anderson. And Anderson and Gardner try and wedge it out of there on the boards, but play has halted. And the faceoff will come at the Team Canada blue line.
Brought back in over the line with players trapped as we look at Glenn Anderson, bothered by a knee injury early. And that's maybe the first good body check of the period as he nails Krutov right up against the boards there. Puck came out over the line, came back in, and that produced the whistle. Shots on goal, Canada with 5, Soviet Union 3. It scored on 2 of the 3.
Here's Makarov. Makarov beating Fetisov, closing in. Krutov scores! Fetisov from Makarov. It's 3-0 for the Soviets.
Oh, the mastery and the wizardry of Makarov, who hung onto that puck, and then just gave it right here. And the overloading of the zone with Fetisov coming in. He was had a clear path to the net, and it's 3-0. And Canada is in shock here at the 8-minute mark. The Soviets have just completely scored on everything. So Fetisov, on every chance that they have had, they have scored.
3-0, the Soviets lead. Canada in game one came from behind a 4-1 deficit to tie it, but it was much later. Here are the Soviets, who are off to the quick start, feeding to Kamensky. Kamensky, number 13, trying to move in. He gets knocked around. Now Bekov, checked by Howardchuk before he could shoot. Bekov again to Stelnov. Hartsburg trying to tie him up. Stelnov still with it. Gets it in front. Cure the save. And then Lemieux cleared it. Gretzky dropping it back. And it's back to Gretzky. Gretzky for Canada. Leaves it for Lemieux. Here's Lemieux to Gretzky. To Mario Lemieux. Lemieux for Canada. And long reach. Tried to go to a one-handed move. Loses it. And Semyonov had it for the moment. Canada still holding in. Gretzky looks for Lemieux. Lemieux to Gretzky, and that's broken up. And now Lemieux shoots Gretzky at the edge of the crease, couldn't tip it in. And the Soviets break up. But now back to the play, a penalty goal for cross-checking against the Soviet Union. And Canada get a bit of a break there because the Soviets were breaking up 2-on-1.
I'm not sure a penalty was called on 99 Gretzky with the one side of the net. The other side of the net was knocked to the ice. Canada guilty of overhandling the puck a little bit. Gretzky, what a chance. Simply just, well, he was covered up very quickly right at the side of the net as Semyonov came over. And there's Gretzky going down under the checking. And Kravchuk, the young defenseman, picks up the minor. And Canada really has to score here.
3-0, the Soviets leading. Makarov to Sarov, and then Fetisov from Makarov on their third goal. Here's Koharski, the referee, and another tribute to him. The Soviets agreeing to a Canadian official in this game, which usually sees neutral officials operate, at least in neutral countries. All officials are neutral, right, Ron?
Exactly. All NHL officials seem to be.
Canada on the power play. They're 0 for 1 in this game tonight with the man advantage, and they're down by 3. Now Messier. Over to Murphy. Murphy moving in, and Canada goes offside at the Soviet blue line.
Mark Messier on the far side getting in a little too quickly. The penalty to Kravchuk at 9:10 for cross-checking. Look at Mark Messier. What a first period he had the other night. Set the tone of the game with his hitting, his speed. And while he seemed to slowly run out of steam, he really picked up his own teammates. See him on the bench. He's a clear leader, not only the Edmonton Oilers, but Team Canada as well.
Canada with the man advantage. Bork and Murphy, the point men, with Anderson, Goulet, and Tocchet up front. Puck dumped in by Bork. Now Anderson digs in against Fetisov. Makarov there to clear it. Knocked down by Canada. Here's Murphy. Shoots, field, and caught the same rebound. Tocchet scores! Rick Tocchet!
Well, they got him in front of the net. This time there was no finesse at all. Murphy again gets it in the slot. This time he elected to shoot. It got behind Molnikov, and Tocchet, trailing on the play, picked up the loose puck. I thought that Team Canada was guilty of overhandling the puck a lot. Just get the shot, go in and look for rebounds. That's the way you play the game over here. And Tocchet was there, got the rebound, and Canada's getting got a very important goal on a power play.
Rick Tocchet gets the goal, his third of this series.
Assisted by number 16,
Goulet will get an assist, as will Murphy. Here's Canada with Murphy leading the attack, trying to get it to Anderson, broken up, and Hovatov, number 15. Hovatov into center ice, gets it to Bekov, number 27. Out of Hovatov, back to Bekov. He's upended by Sutter, and Brent Sutter will get a penalty here. And now Canada will be shorthanded, holding against Sutter. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Pontiac Tempest joins the Pontiac Heatwave.
The heat is on. On the street, inside your head. It's the Pontiac.
Introducing the all-new 1988 Pontiac Tempest, a compact sedan that'll blow the competition out of town.
Oh, 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 tell me, can you feel it? Tell me, can you feel it? Pontiac, the heat is on, it's on the street.
Sutter goes off for holding just seconds after Canada had gotten on the board. That's Bekov, number 27, and it just got the clutch put on him by Sutter. Not an opportune penalty. Canada trying to get some momentum going. Trailing 3-1 in the game. Canada's really got the edge in terms of offense. They just haven't been able to get Molnikov. 10-5 shots on goal right now for Team Canada.
But 3-1 for the Soviets. Canada able to clear it out of there. The Dotov back to get it into his own zone. Now dropping it back to Fedotov again as Kamienski gave it to him. Return to Kamienski, number 13. To Bekov, number 27. To Hovatov, number 15. Now to Fedotov, and his pass across to Gusarov. Tipped away by Messier. Gusarov over to Bekov. Drops it. Hovatov checked in. Here's Gilmore for Canada. Gartner shoots right on. Glove save Milnikov as Gilmore put Gartner in on the right side. Back comes Bekov to Hovatov. Hovatov around Rochefort moving in. Gilmore trying to tie him up. Now to Fetisov at the point. Back on the boards. Soviets with the power play. Behind the net, put right through the crease, and Kasatonov missed it at the edge of the crease, and now Homatov down on the ice and shaken up, and that's why play has been halted.
Rather desperate situation for Team Canada, as Gartner had been playing that whole sequence without his stick. His stick lying broken down on the ice. Homatov went down to the side of the net with that little shot, which was something more than just a little shot. Trying to get in front of the net. They're prepared to pay the price a little bit. Oh, Homatov goes to the bench. Seventh season veteran. And his third Canada Cup. Like Bekov, very small and shifty, but quite a hockey player.
They call him the Soviet rat, huh? I know the.
We never told him.
I know the hit was a little illegal, but the fall was rather dramatic as well.
Well, you see, Bill Barber played. I learned a few things.
3-1, Soviets leading, 57 seconds left in Canada's penalty. Kasatonov back to get it. To Krutov. Into Larionov. That play is offside at the Soviet blue line.
Good check at the line. Krutov took a good shot. This is a good, clean hit. This is what hockey's about. Boom. Two tough guys, because Krutov, he'll take those checks and come right back at you, but so will Messier.
Train number 11. He is strong.
The guy was on his way back to his feet. The whistle went on the offside.
Still 44 seconds left in Canada's penalty to Sutter. Messier out there against Larionov on this faceoff. And those two fellas have got to know each other very well during this 1987 Canada Cup. Larionov just gets to know Messier a little bit better as he gives him a jab from the faceoff. Bork trying to clear it, but Fetisov held it in. Shot blocked by Bork to Anderson. Anderson tied up by Fetisov. Now knocked away from Anderson. And Canada having to drop back with Larry Murphy. Murphy loses to Makarov, but as soon as Makarov touched the puck, it was called on a delayed offside.
Very smart play by Murphy. He knew he had the free pass on the delayed whistle, so he circled back inside his own zone. Moment as Soviet touched the puck, the whistle was going to go anyway, so he killed off some precious seconds, and the power play situation for the Soviet now is down to 21 seconds. Now Murphy, knowing there's a delayed whistle here, circles back. Killed off 4, 5, 6 seconds, maybe the difference. Finally, Makarov moved in and checked him.
21 seconds left in the penalty. Hartsburg for Canada. Clears it away. Gilmore and Gartner are up front. With Rochefort and Hartsburg on defense. Here's Gartner trying to center. Intercepted by Stelnov. Now to Samak, number 18. Samak shot off of Hartsburg. Rochefort beats Semyonov to it, clearing it. There's Kropchuk pinching in. To Semyonov. Now Lomakin back of the net with Samak. Samak trying to center. To Lomakin. Back to Stelnov. Shooting. That's just wide. Bounced in front, and Gilmore couldn't get it out of there. Semyonov held it in. Lomakin has it, but now Brent Sutter out of the penalty box. Canada back at full strength. And here's Sutter trying to break away. Sutter gets knocked down. Gretzky follows up. Cleared it in. Stelnov. Bumped by Gretzky. Delno flipping it. And into center ice. Samak loses. And here's Howardchuk trying to get it to Lemieux. Samak to Lomakin, and Copy took it away from him. Trying to get it to Gretzky. Lomakin intercepts. And the Soviets with Kropchuk shoot it into Canada's zone. Muir clears it out. Here's Lemieux. Into Howardchuk. Usarov back to get it. Clearing it out onto the boards. Priyakin shoots it to center. Crossman over for Copy, now to Gretzky. Ahead on the wing for Howardchuk. And that's intercepted by Priyakin. Canada again in control. Stick handling in neatly. It's Howardchuk to Lemieux, but offside is the play at the Soviet blue line. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Good times ain't hard. Good friends, the backyard.
fans are up for it here in Hamilton, Ontario. Really enjoying an absolute sellout. They had a big lineup here at the Copps Coliseum yesterday morning. The final tickets were gobbled up in very short order. And the scalpers have been having a field day ever since. Reminder, during our first intermission, Doug Gilmore is going to be around. We'll have some highlights of the first two games of this championship round. Set to music. They're pretty spectacular, too. Brad Park will have his highlights on the Toyota scoreboard with Dan Kelly.
Here's Team Canada down 3-1. Michel Goulet firing it in. And Fetisov back to get it. Fetisov to Bekov. Now to Kamienski. Kamienski upended, but clears it to Team Canada's line. Coffey fired it back out. Here's Kamienski. Over to Homotap, number 15. He just dumps it in. Murphy back for Canada. Murphy missing Coffey with a pass. Here's Bekov to Homotap. Homotap flips it in. Now Muir giving it to Gretzky. Winding it around under the boards. Fetisov pinching in. Fetisov centered, loose in front. Canada come up with it, and here's Lemieux to Gretzky. Gretzky with Lemieux. Upended on the play as Gretzky, and Bekov has it. Now Krutov holding it in. Kasatonov back to get it. Right in front of his own goal to Fetisov. And the Soviet veteran defenseman Fetisov to Makarov to Bekov. Back to Makarov, right in. Muir came out and made a big save. As Makarov was right in at the doorstep. Now a pass to Tockett, misses him. Kasatonov back to get it. Almost stolen by Canada on the play as Krop got his stick on it. Now here's Bork from center ice firing it in. Back to Stelno. Into forecheck is Tockett. Rick Tockett. Gets some help from Brent Sutter out in front. They score!
Fired across the goal mouth. Well, it was a bad start for Canada, but they're back in it. Krop is on the goal side at this side of the net. Here's a closer view. Krop is number 26, looks to the right of the net. Now he moves into position. Out comes Sutter, throws it across. Don't get cute. That's the story of the two goals for Team Canada. All they've done, Tockett again with a great job forechecking, produced the puck, and Krop gets credit for the goal.
Brian Krop at 15:23 here in the first period. To cut the Soviets lead to 3-2. Tockett gets an assist. As the first is Brent Sutter. 15:23 the time. Soviets lead has been cut to 3-2. Here's James Patrick. In across the line to Messier, to Gartner. Milnikov a save, and Gusarov clears it to Lomakin, who shot at the center. Patrick giving it to Messier. Fired in. Going back, big Gusarov takes a hit from Gartner on the play. And now Semyonov at center. Into Samak. Samak trying to move in, does, shoots. Save by Fuhr on Samak. And then he sputtered it. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Hi, I'm Holly Doan, late night news anchor here on 23 TV, reminding you that I'll be here later tonight with all the latest in news, weather, and of course the sports highlights. You know, we late night people are able to watch David Letterman every night right after the news. And a special treat every Saturday with It's Gary Shandling Show, right after Tommy Banks Jazz. We won't miss the debut episode this Saturday, and you shouldn't either, right here.
23 TV.
Mike Gartner on a delayed whistle, laid the check of the game. Right here as he just leveled. Well, he didn't level him, but he sure came up against the boards on Gusarov, who's a pretty solid guy. Gartner, who played hurt through the first part of this tournament, a very sore wrist, which wouldn't allow him to shoot the puck to any great extent, met as part of his game. But he told me this morning that the problem is now cured. hasn't really been bothering him too much. It's still sore, but at least he can control his stick. There's Messier. Feelings are running high a bit. That probably followed something else. Homotov there.
Imchinov on a faceoff against Brent Sutter. Deep in Canada's zone. 4:07 left in the period. Fetisov at the point. Skate saved by Fuhr, and then the rebound is just poked away. Ryokin couldn't get it in front, and here's Brent Sutter to board. Now tipped by Hartsburg and fired in by Tockett. Tockett has scored for Canada and set up another. Here's Tockett with a shot wide of the net. Bork flipping it in, and he flipped it up over the boards at the Soviet bench. So some of the grinders, such as Rick Tockett, playing hurt but coming through big for Canada.
Well, I don't know who got the worst of this, but Sutter and Tockett, I think Tockett probably took the brunt of that check, which was originally intended for Kasatonov back there. Tockett coming to the bench to shake it off a little bit. There's Tockett there. Tockett and Sutter just arriving at the bench. Boy, that Tockett, for a guy who's supposed to have a tender knee, is really doing it. He's scored a goal. He's assisted on a goal, started the play in the corner when he dug the puck loose and got it to Sutter. It led to Propp's goal that has made it a 3-2 hockey game.
Here's Gretzky, Lemieux, and Anderson now for Canada. Coffey and Murphy on defense. Soviets with their line of Bekov, Kamensky, and Homotov up front.
And we'd like to remind you that the Labatt player of the game for Canada will receive the new Canon EOS autofocus that never misses. Stop the game with the only autofocus camera quick enough to capture all the action. The Canon EOS, the official 35mm camera of the 1988 Olympic Winter Games.
Play just underway. Canada shooting it in. Back to get it. Here's Lemieux stealing it in front to Anderson as Lemieux beat Kropchuk to the puck. Now Anderson, side of the net to Lemieux. And Milner top came out and cleared it. Gretzky to Murphy. Murphy shoots up high into the crowd. The Wayne and Mario show starting to gear up.
Murphy had to do that all over again. He would have wished that the puck had come to the stick flat. I think he had a bouncing, rolling puck. He had to cradle first and then tee it up. And then, of course, the defenseman was able to move over.
We're talking about Gretzky, or as we look at Murphy, we're talking about Gretzky and Lemieux, who now lead the ice. I guess you could say Gretzky loads the gun and Mario pulls the trigger.
That's about it. That probably is the best way to describe it.
Here's Canada on the faceoff. Patrick firing it around, over to pick it up to Sarov, out to Makarov. Leaving it there for Fedotov, number 14. Larionov cleared it in, but it's offside as Krutov was in ahead of the play.
Shots on goal continue to be 2-1 favor Canada, 16-8 now. Canada with a total of 16 shots already in this game with 2:57 remaining in the first period. Gretzky the captain.
Now, two different times, Ron, I've seen Wayne Gretzky get 5 goals in a game. I think the best game I've ever seen him play was the other night. He didn't have a goal. He had 5 assists and was all over the place.
5 straight assists. There's a high stick. Makarov one and an inadvertent one on that. When Anderson was turning at the boards and puck seemed to, you can see Makarov's reaction. Stick seemed to ride up on the stick of Anderson. Cut him across the face. There's going to be a high sticking call. Makarov, good call. Now here it is. They're still responsible for your stick. And if it gets up above the shoulders, then you have to pay the price, no matter whether it's accidental or not. Well, Canada goes on the power play.
Canada 1-for-2 with the man advantage in this game. Canada's power play goal of the Canada Cup. So Canada with Lemieux, Messier, and Gretzky up front. Copy and Bork, the point man. Here's Copy to Messier. Leaving it for Lemieux. He left it there for Messier. Into Lemieux, back of the net to Gretzky. On the point to Bork, and then broken up by Larionov, who tipped off the center. Bork has to hustle back. 2:20 left in the first period. 3-2 Soviets. Bork to Messier. Back to Bork. Ahead to Gretzky, and he just tips it in. Now Lemieux behind the goal. Krutov couldn't get it. Lemieux back to Bork. Around to the other side to Gretzky. Trying to tip it to Messier. And the Soviets get it. Coffey held it in. His shot wide. Here's Lemieux. To Bork, to Coffey. Over to Gretzky. Back to Coffey. Other side to Bork. Shot blocked by Becca. Bork with 49 seconds left in the penalty to Coffey. Stick save, Mildekov. Gretzky to Coffey. Over to Lemieux. Couldn't handle a pass. To Messier, who lets it go to Gretzky. On the point to Bork. Over to Coffey. Now to Bork with 30 seconds left in the penalty. Back to Coffey. Over to Gretzky. Soviets playing that box. Side of the net to Messier. Back to Gretzky. Now to Coffey. Shooting. Mildekov save. And Mario Lemieux couldn't get the rebound. Now he does. To Messier. Messier shoots from a bad angle. Kasatonov blocked that. We're in the final minute of the period. 4 seconds left of the penalty. Gretzky to Coffey. Over to Bork. Penalized player back on. Bork lets the shot go. Block. And Krutov cleared it. Now Bork a shot. Gretzky deflects. Off the goal post with that one. And the Soviets, Makarov clearing the center. Bork back to get it. Bork blows it. Kolmatov in the clear. Scores! Kolmatov on a breakaway. And the Soviets on a late goal take a 4-2 lead here in the first period.
Well, we got back to the problem that I think that Team Canada was in the early stages of the period. They tried to get too cute. And here's Kolmatov all alone, and nearly a great save by Grant Fuhr, but it trickled over the line. Puck was just stripped away as falling on the play was Bork, and Kolmatov had the clear path. But going back to the power play, it's almost like when you get Gretzky and Messier and also Lemieux out there, they want to score the perfect goal. Take a look at the two goals that have been scored for Team Canada tonight. It's been on sheer muscle and throw it in front of the net and bang it into the net. Now, we've had Gretzky and Lemieux score great goals in this tournament, but there they were almost like they were looking for the perfect and perfect goal, and they certainly didn't get it because the Soviets just played the box perfectly.
Now Canada down by two again. 17 seconds left in the period. Prop in there digging on the board. Soviets able to clear it, and Roshbor has to go back. Roshbor just scooping it into center ice, and it goes up over the boards at the Team Canada bench with 4 seconds left in the first period. Kolmatov unassisted, 19:32, the time of that goal.
Well, we've got one of those games again, and don't go away because we've seen leads before disintegrate and go away. And the Soviets had their 3-0 lead reduced to 3-2.
There's a long shot that Mildekov handles, and he heads to the locker room with his team leading 4-2.
Shots on goal in the period. Canada outshot the Soviets 19-9, but the Soviets scored 4 goals on those 9 shots and some pretty glaring errors that led to the goals.
This goes to show you again that shots on goal statistic is not a good one. 4-2, the Soviets lead after 20 minutes here in Hamilton. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
There's a new standard in fresh ground coffee taste. Introducing new Taster's Choice premium ground coffees. At last, the choice is yours.
Selling your home can be an isolating experience. But with a Century 21 office, you may not wait long for your ship to come in.
Hello?
Rob, I'd like to bring a family over. How's Friday?
He's fine, thanks.
Mr. Crusoe, the Robinsons. They're a Swiss family, Robinson.
This place is really awesome.
Last year, we put over 1 million buyers and sellers together, one home at a time. Century 21, the largest real estate organization in the world.
When you consider how big it is...
You know what makes it so big? All those peanuts!
It's not surprising there's so much inside.
It's that big chunk of fudge. I'm telling you, it's all that caramel. It's that big chunk of fudge.
Oh, Henry, what makes it big makes it good.
So how do we get down?
What do you call a car with this much styling outside and so much room inside? What do you call a family car with the efficiency and performance of a 16-valve engine? What do you call a car the Automobile Journalists Association of Canada called the best imported sedan? What do you call a car with a 5-year, 100,000-kilometer powertrain warranty? We call it Camry. You'll call it incredible. The 1987 Toyota Camry. Who could ask for anything more?
Your face takes enough abuse, so Gillette introduces the new Good News Plus disposable. Its Luber Smooth Strip is designed to reduce irritation, so shaving feels so good. New Good News Plus.
After a one period of play in Hamilton, Game 3 of the best of three Canada Cup final, the Soviets lead 4-2. One member of Team Canada that scored a goal in each of the previous two playoff games against the Soviets joins us now, Doug Gilmore. And Doug, we were just chatting as we got in position here. It's going to be uphill again. Why is it so often uphill against these guys?
I really don't know. We talked about it in the dressing room before, and it's not our game plan to come out this low, but they've jumped all over us a couple times, and now, like you said, it's uphill again for us, and we got to be ready these next two periods there. You know, it's all going to be all over.
They were sky high in this building as this game was getting set to start. What was the feeling like in the dressing room?
We were ready. You know, the crowd is great here, but we were talking about it, but mentally we thought we were ready, but when we came on the ice, we weren't. So we just got to regroup. Everybody's got to get back together and take it shift by shift. We can't have one good shift and the next shift let down. We all got to work together as a team and keep on going.
They scored three times on their first four shots on goal. Really put you in a big hole in the first half of that period. It seemed to me as if the play of the muckers and grinders started to bring the team to life. Tockett and Sutter, the guys doing the smacking and banging.
Yeah, that's what we have to do mostly. We have to get the puck in there, and mostly the guys like Tockett on the ice and, you know, Sudsy. You just got to get the puck in there. You got to work and keep on throwing the puck and hit Fetisov, hit that
Kasatonov,
and they'll cough the puck up, those guys. You got to hit them, though. If you don't get on them quick, that, you know, they're great players.
Does this team that you have on the ice right now, less Claude Lemieux, less Kevin Dineen, do you have enough hitting throughout the entire lineup? You've got a couple of hitters left.
Sure we do. You know, everybody can hit, everybody can do everything. You just got to get in there, get on them. We don't give them the puck. You got to throw it around the boards where the wingers can get to it and make things happen. And I think this period we're going to come out, it's going to be a different ballgame.
Well, we've talked during this telecast that with all the talent on Team Canada, it looks from time to time as if the players are trying to make the perfect play, the pretty play. So often that doesn't work.
A lot of times we are. You know, Mr. Kenyon says before every game, shoot the puck. I got in some heck the other game for not shooting the puck in the slot. And that's one thing we got to bear down on. Just keep shooting. And, you know, hopefully if it's a bad goal, who cares? You know, long as it goes in.
No, it doesn't matter how pretty it looks, it still counts. Does this team have a glaring weakness, the Soviet team? Does it have a weakness that you can work on?
I think if we box them up really quick, you know, in a sense, in the neutral ice zone, we take the man, get the puck back in there and work them, and they'll start standing around. That's the only way we're going to beat them. If they start freewheeling, we're not going to stay up with them.
Mike Keenan talks continuously, nonstop, about defensive posture. This is far too early in the hockey game to talk about opening up, I assume.
Oh, it is. For sure it is. You know, all we need is one more goal. We're back in the game, and, you know, we can work on one more after that. But we need one in the first 10 minutes of this period coming up, but we can't give them anything.
Mm-hmm. You know, normally when we introduce a player, we'd say Doug Gilmore of the St. Louis Blues plays center. On this team, it's Doug Gilmore plays any position up front. How does that feel for a player?
Feels great. All I can say, I'm on the ice. I don't care where I am, what position, as long as I get on.
Doug, thanks very much. Good luck
to you.
Doug Gilmore, St. Louis Blues, Team Canada trailing after one period of play to the Soviets 4-2. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
The unique Royal LePage pre-approved mortgage. With it, shopping for your dream home is a joy. Without it, shopping for a mortgage after finding a house can be a nightmare. One you can avoid with our pre-approved mortgage. We guarantee rates equal to or lower than the five major banks. Bypass mortgage hassles. Buy your house on the spot because you're pre-approved. Ask your Royal LePage representative about our pre-approved mortgage.
Oh, when the saints,
oh, when the saints,
oh, when the saints,
oh, when the saints,
oh, when the saints, in, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in.
If you have a miserable cold, you deserve the hot lemon relief of Neocitrin.
Oh, when the warmth, oh, when the warmth comes soothing through.
Soothing, effective Neocitrin. If you have a cold, may the saint be with you.
For the best protection in a tough game, nothing tops the Cooper Oil Girdle except this. Introducing the new Upper Body Protector. The next step in the Cooper Oil system. Lightweight and comfortable, it stays with you on impact. Flexing and protecting like a second skin. Get the Cooper Oil Upper Body Protector, part of the Cooper Oil system, because when you get hit in the game of hockey, you get hit hard.
Nobody in Canada competes like Chrysler. When you wanted the best warranty, Chrysler came through with 7-year or 115,000 kilometer protection. Now Chrysler announces dealer inventory cashbacks. $750 on Canada K. $1,000 on Chrysler LeBaron GTS Premium. $750 on Chrysler New Yorker. And many more. For warranty protection and now cashbacks, nobody competes like Chrysler.
Canada had the edge in play in that first period, but the Soviets had the edge around the goal, and they lead by a pair. But of course, one period does not a game make. Witness the first two games of the series, both of which went to overtime. 6-5 in both games, once for the Soviets, once for Canada. It's been a rock and roll affair. those of you joining us for the first time in this series, do not despair. One team has been up by two goals after the first period in the previous two games. 4-2 Soviets, lots of hockey to come right after Brad Park's highlights and analysis. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
In the beginning, many investments look alike. They generate capital gains and income, or at least they try. But look closer and you'll see that some make more money than others, consistently. Over the last 19 years, the Industrial Group of Funds from Mackenzie Financial has proven that to more than 300,000 Canadian investors. Looking to see your investment soar? Talk to your investment fund dealer or stockbroker. The Industrial Group of Funds, looking both ways to manage your money.
Honda would like to show you something you've never seen before. Four-wheel steering. Four-wheel steering from Honda. Only on the new Prelude SI. It's an incredible turn of events.
The Soviet shooting percentage very close to 50% in that first period. 9 shots on goal, 4 went in. Brad Park is our analyst, and he's going to tell you why.
Tell you why. Well, if you sit up there and you've watched it long enough, you know that the one problem that any team has is when the defense gives up the blue line. And Team Canada is so wary of the Russian forwards that they're creating a tremendous gap. And we're going to look at that all the way through our highlights, and we're also going to show you why. We're going to look at the first highlight, and this is in the first shift of the game. Here's Makarov. Look at the gap and how the Soviets gain the blue line with no problem. They're moving at full speed. The Canadian fence is standing still. Makarov to the net. Good save by Grant Fuhr. The second highlight is the same shift that leads to the game, the goal. Look at this gap. We're looking at Larionov coming through the middle. He's looking over, moves it back. Here comes Krutov. I mean, these guys are all over him. That blue line is wide open. Now we've got Krutov going to the net. It's just unbelievable what's happening here. The guys are just getting too much room to move over. Wayne Gretzky goes behind the net. Now watch how quickly the puck turns over, goes in front of the net. Krutov to Makarov. Boom, 1-0. That's the very first shift of the game. Twice the blue line was given up and created problems. The next highlight is Fetisov's goal. Now here's Makarov with the puck again. Watch how easy he gains the blue line. The forwards are looking for wingers and not taking anybody through center ice. Makarov holding off the puck. Here comes Fetisov moving at full speed. Everybody's standing still because it's the late man coming through. Fetisov, great play to his forehand. Boom, makes it 3-0 very quickly for the Soviets. What we want to look at right now is show you why these things happen. We're not going to get a look at that. What we're going to look at is the pressure and the last goal that they scored. Here's Ray Bork, Makarov on him very quickly. Now these Soviets can skate. Bork pivots, his skates lose the edge. He goes down here because Hamatov moves in, and what a beautiful goal he makes on Grant Fuhr. Just enough to trickle through and over the goal line. These are things that are happening. Now this is part of the things that the Canadians did bounce back. They did bounce back on the power play. Watch, Makarov have a tough time. Hits the referee, skate Koharski. Glenn Anderson to Murphy. Larry Murphy walks in. Great wrist shot. Tough for Melnikov to handle it. Goes in the crease. Here's Rick Tocchet driving through the net and plants it home. Canada, that got them back in the game, created a lot of spirit. They came back with a second goal. But, you know, right now the Soviets are just playing too strong.
Is it that thing that everyone was talking about so many weeks ago, Canada's defense?
Defense is not strictly defensemen. What's happening, and you have to watch for it in the second period, the Soviet forwards leave their end in hurry, and they leave it quickly, which forces the Canadian defense to back up. Now the Canadian forwards are coming back, and they decide to go and pick up a winger at the blue line, which means you've got the defenseman standing still at the blue line, the Soviet forwards coming 100 miles an hour. You can't help it back in.
Well, we'll see if things change shortly. We're almost set to start the second period. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
With so many automatic features, Zenith's new smaller VHS camcorder not only lets you take perfect pictures, it lets you show them again and again. Zenith. Quality.
Pontiac Tempest joins the Pontiac Heatwave.
The heat is on the street, inside your head. It's the Pontiac beat,
and the beat's alive.
Introducing the all-new 1988 Pontiac Tempest, a compact sedan that'll blow the competition out of town.
Oh, 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 tell me, can you feel it? Tell me.
There's a new standard in fresh ground coffee taste. Introducing new Taster's Choice premium ground coffees. At last, the choice is yours.
Our Toyota scoring summary after one period. Three in a row by the Soviets. Makarov at the 26-second mark. Gusarov at 7:04. Then Fetisov at the 8-minute mark to make it 3-0. Canada got a power play goal from Tocket at 9:50, then Prop scoring at 15:23 to make it close, but then the late goal by Homotop at 19:32. Shots on goal, Canada 19, Soviets 9, but the scoreboard tells a much different tale. Our Toyota scoring summary brought to you by Toyota, makers of the economical fun to drive Tercel. Who could ask for anything more?
Well, look at that goal by Homotov right near the end of the period, and it could be a big, big goal for the Soviet Union. They went into the dressing room, of course, on a high. They'd seen a 3-0 lead disintegrate to 3-2. Now they lead 4-2. Unfortunate thing for Team Canada, they just finished a power play. Ray Bourque had been on the ice for the full 2 minutes of the power play. Suddenly, he is checked by Makarov. The puck pops free. And in goes Homotov, unassisted, to score. A big, big goal, and we'll see how big as this game unfolds. Somehow, I don't think this game is going to end up with a 4-2 final score. There's the way it has been in Canada Cup since the beginning, way back in 1976. In 76, of course, Canada played the Soviet Union only once, and that was in the preliminary round. Czechoslovakia played Canada in the final. 1981, there was a 7-3 victory in the preliminary round, but then in that final, a disastrous 8-1 victory for the Soviet Union. 1984, 6-3 Soviets in the preliminary round, but then Canada in that wonderful overtime game in the semifinal. And of course, here in 1987, dead even through three games, and now we're into the second period of the fourth game.
And immediately, Canada clear the puck into the Soviet zone. Makarov is there, number 24. Back he comes, trying to go around Patrick. Tipped away by Canada, and Buehr away out of the net to clear that. Here's Fetisov trying to hold it in. And again, it's Rochefort with a lead pass to Messier. Kasatonov and Messier. There's Messier trying to center, was tipped away, and Kasatonov gives it to Makarov, who speeds in on left wing. Patrick takes him out of the play. Gartner cleared it. Here's Krutov. Centering back, Larionov to Fetisov. Six save pure on Fetisov. Fetisov still with it for the Soviets. Got it in front, batted away by Rochefort. Now Patrick, number 6, from the New York Rangers, leaving it for Rochefort. Up the middle to Gartner, tipped in, and shot right back out by number 29, Kravchuk. Into center ice. Here's Krutov moving in. Hartsburg dives to break it up. Now dropped back, and Kropchuk is checked by Krop. Gretzky breaks away with Tocket. 2-on-1. Gretzky to Tocket. Fanned on it from about 20 feet out. Now Krop after the loose puck. And it's Homotop breaking out of there. Homotop, number 15, bumped off the puck. Krop drops it back. Coffee clearing one. And Kropchuk goes back to try and clear it, and does. Bekov. Now it's called on an offside at the Soviet blue line, and that's the way the second period begins.
There's Paul Coffey, been very strong throughout this tournament. Again, his speed is so much a part of his game. A two-time Norris Trophy winner. Quite often he is paired with fellows who have controlled the Norris Trophy the last 3 years. Of course, Ray Bourque won it in 1987.
Canada down by 4-2. Coffey living it for Greg Hartsburg. Lifted it to center. Prop is checked. Now Coffey picks it up. Canada playing catch up. Coffey to Gretzky, knocked away from him. And
Here's Samak beating one to Bekov, moves in, shoots, Fjord just got his glove on it. Rebound, Bekov, a shot. Fjord stops that and cleared it away. And Tocket beats Gretzky. That's knocked away. Kamienski now for the Soviets, firing it back in. Coffey back to pick it up. Paul Coffey leads a four-man Canada rush. Fedotov there to clear it. Coffey holding his ground on the boards against Fedotov. Gretzky comes in to try and pry it loose, and finally it's held for a faceoff. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
There's no sign of life. It's just the bar's a charm. I'm lying in the rain.
Interesting strategy here by Mike Keenan as the second period begins. He's split up Gretzky and Lemieux. And Lemieux is now out there with Sutter and Gulick. Semyonov against Lemieux on the faceoff. And the Soviets break out of there. Lomachin number 23 against Bork. Bork rides him out of the play. Bork clearing it up to Michel Gulick. Shot to center. Gusarov over to Fedotov. Out of Semyonov, number 30. Fires it in. Samak in after it. Samak to Lomachin. Shot off a skate wide. Here's Semyonov. He's checked, and here's Lemieux. Has Goulet and Sutter with him. Broken up. Sutter the trailer. Centered it. But shot away by Gusarov for the Soviets. Fjord scooping it up on the boards to Murphy. Murphy shot at the center. Fetisov intercepts there. And gives it to number 8, Kubalev. At center now to Fetisov. Upended by Bork on the play. Priyakin into the corner, but Fetisov cleared it around. Kasatonov to Priyakin. Brent Sutter ties him up, and Larry Murphy has it. He gives it to Bork. Back on the wing, Sutter shot at the center. Intercepted by Priyakin. Bork trying to ride him up. Priyakin and Bork now. Nemchinov knocked down back to the net by Howard Duck. Here's Humalep trying to center. Nemchinov to Priyakin. And he skated off, and Gretzky trying to chip it up. Soviets hold it in. Here comes Gretzky. Deep move, Gretzky. Looking to make a play. Gretzky still with it. Checked from behind by Hovalap, who's able to shoot it out of there. And going back is Hartsburg. To Coffey, into center ice to Gilmore, but Krutov intercepts. He drops it back to Kasatonov. Fired up the middle, and here is Larionov. Hartsburg breaks that up. Beating Anderson to Messier. Back to Anderson, Kasatonov cleared it. Messier to Anderson. Back on the boards, Krutov. Has Larionov and Makarov with him, a three-on-three break. Pass to Makarov, flipped in front. Krutov was there, but couldn't make the deflection. Anderson for Canada. Got it outside the line, carried back in offside by the Soviets. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
You've heard about those 5, 6, 7 year warranties, but do you know where their coverage really ends? Right here, powertrain only. The Mazda Leadership Warranty is bumper to bumper for 3 years or 80,000 kilometers, and all major components for 5 years or 100,000 kilometers. The 1988 Mazda Leadership Warranty, the best in the business.
Assignment is Sergei Makarov. Now take a look at this little play with the knee. Now Makarov got up and made a play right after that, but he took him out of the play long enough that he wasn't clear when he got up. He wound up with the puck, shot the puck wide of the net.
Now Lemieux out there with prop and tocket for Canada. Here's Rochefort flipping it into center ice. And the newcomer Kropchuk is there to shoot it back up. Now controlled by Stelnov, number four. Ahead onto the wing. Here's Kamienski moving in, trying to center to Homotop. Broken up and Canada's Crossman cleared it. Prop sliding it all the way down the ice. And it's grabbed by Milnikov. As then Stelnov and Lemieux bump into each other after the whistle.
Well, Coffey, he was had his problems over a period of time with his skates, adjusting them once again. 4-2, the Soviets leading Canada. I guess it's more his shin guard than his skates. Last year, he had a dreadful time of it through the first part of the season. Just couldn't find a pair of skates that fit him properly. Was in a slump. Got over that, and of course, finished strongly and led the team to a Stanley Cup.
Now Canada with a forward line of Howard Chuck, Goulet, and James Patrick up front, normally a defenseman. Rochefort and Crossman on defense. Howard Chuck gets the draw. Shot by Rochefort, deflects just wide. Milnikov took no chance as it came off the backboards and just smothered it.
Well, one thing when you've got a defenseman up on your forward line in a faceoff in the offensive zone, he's the kind of guy who can go right into that goal mouth area. He's used to the traffic in there, and he has to face that kind of traffic defending his own zone. There's a young player who's shown a lot of promise in this tournament. Anatoly Fedotov. Be around for a long time. Plays for Moscow Dynamo.
He's 21 years of age. I think Tikhanov is intense. Here's a drive by Canada. Rochefort let it go. Milnikov making the stop back of the net. Gusarov trying to clear it out of there. And it's carried out by Lomakin, number 23. Crossman checked him. Now Fedotov wide with that shot. And Rochefort takes Homotov out of the play with a tough check. Canada can't get it out. Semyonov holding it in. Well wide with that shot. Now cleared in by Fedotov, and Rochefort has it for Canada. Rochefort up the middle to Howardchuk. He's upended, and he's hurt as Gusarov caught him right at center ice. And Howardchuk is shaken up. And now Gusarov goes down. I didn't see what happened to him. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
For a limited time, McDonald's presents Double Features.
It's back.
But it's not alone.
The return of the famous McDonald's Double Hamburger. A masterpiece for only $1.25. And the famous McDonald's Double Cheeseburger. It's back for a return engagement. Unforgettable. Two all-beef patties. Melted processed cheese. A sensation for only $1.45. McDonald's Double Features. An incredible taste, an incredible deal. Just till October 12th.
Chuck very upset at the hit he took from Gusarov in the center ice zone. Then Gusarov was nailed by Rochefort afterwards as a retaliatory measure. Koharski didn't see that. He was looking at the original incident, and this is why Fetisov is arguing. Watch to the left of your screen here. You'll see in the center ice zone, Howardchuk is kneed perhaps by Gusarov. Gusarov went down to defend in his own zone. And he was nailed by Rochefort and went down himself. There's Gusarov. Another good young defenseman of this team. He's 23 years of age.
No penalties on either play. Soviets 4, Canada 2. Soviets led 3-1 after the first period of game 1. Made it 4-1. Canada came back eventually to tie it. Game 2. Canada led 3-1 after one, and the Soviets came back to tie it. So two goals, but these teams, differential after one period, not proving to be that much. Here's Hartsburg decking Himmelap with a check as he caught him with his head down. Now Priyakin racing in. Canada starting to throw their weight around, and it's shot out by Tocket down the ice. Kasatonov going back together. And it's icing called against Canada.
Wow, a couple of great hits. Hartsburg was the one that started it. And Hartsburg in a foul mood with the scoreboard reading 4-2. Somebody said something to him, but a good clean hit in the center ice zone. And then a couple of hits down in the Team Canada zone. Here it comes right to your screen. He nailed him, stood him straight up, sat him straight down. And they're going to have to do a little more of that. Looks like they're getting a little mad, and I think probably that may be the best thing that could happen to Team Canada. They played the first period a little less than total enthusiasm.
Hit, but they better stay out of the penalty
box. That's right. Keep them clean. Keep the sticks down.
Here's Crossman for Canada to Gartner. He couldn't get it out. Krutov has it for the Soviets. Over to Makarov. Rockport bumps him hard. And Canada then clear it out of there. Anderson sliding at the center ice. Now Fetisov passing it up on the wing to Krutov. Rockport back to get it. Messier, Anderson, and Gartner up front. Here's Messier leaving it for Anderson. He's checked, and Makarov breaks away with only Rockport back. He has Krutov with him to Krutov. Shoots, hole pure. Just got a piece of that, and it trickled off to the corner. And Crossman has it for Canada. Delno pinching in. Now Messier. Messier loses. Makarov trying to carry back in. Crossman tying it up. And a jam up in the corner. Rossport coming up with it, flips it out. It hits Makarov as he was going to the bench. Now Crossman cleared once. Delno jammed in there by Anderson. And it's held, and we get a stoppage in play. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
I got you. I know I got you.
You got 88 Toyota trucks coming in.
And 87s are still here.
So I'll take this Toyota off your hands if...
You give me a real deal.
Yeah, make me a deal right now.
Because I don't have much time.
And you don't either.
Take advantage of your Toyota dealer right now, because he's got to move the 87s awfully fast, and that can mean the best deals of the year.
Hey, I know I got you.
So get them while they still got them.
On the right there is Larionov. On the left was Krutov, but it's Makarov who paved the way for this play. And the shot by Krutov just trickled through and behind. Boy, they have been dangerous, especially in this game. Dan Makarov, he is having a great hockey game.
When they get a scoring chance, it's a dandy. They seem to be wide open. And that's why the shots on goal don't mean very much. But chances are good. Bekov flipping it in. Pure there to clear it. Lemieux couldn't get it. Stelno held it in. Wark blocked his shot. Flips it up the middle. And it's shot back in by the Soviets. Now Lemieux and Gretzky are out on the forward line back together with Prop, the other member of that trio. Here comes Murphy into Lemieux. Lemieux cutting in. Lemieux trying to center. Does to Bork. Bork got it in front. Gretzky in front. And Lemieux was upended. And there'll be a penalty to Bekov as he tripped Lemieux at the side of the net. And a Canada power play coming right up. Bekov to the penalty box. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Your Texaco retailer isn't faster than a speeding bullet. He can't leap tall buildings in a single bound. And he's slightly less powerful than a locomotive. But when you need service, he's there. Besides, he's a super guy. Expect more from Texaco.
Will that be all?
You got a phone booth around here?
Vyacheslav Bekov goes off for tripping Mario Lemieux. A great chance here. Watch Gretzky. Here is the puck rolling loose. Gretzky gets a little bit of a piece of it, rolls it. I don't know how he got that pass away, and then Bekov just nailed Lemieux in the goal mouth area, and that drew the tripping penalty. It's the second time that Lemieux has drawn a penalty in this game. As they draw a penalty, his check has taken a penalty trying to handle him. But 8:24, Canada goes on the power play, and the crowd here is starting to pick it up once again.
Gretzky up front with Lemieux and Tockett. Murphy and Bork will be the point men. Canada 1-for-3 on the power play tonight. trailing 4-2, but with a chance here. And now Gretzky wanted to talk to someone, I believe.
He's showing the linesman
that something's on the ice.
And now he's going to go over and discuss things while the linesmen are busy with Mike Keenan. One thing he can do is just kind of. Here are the scoring leaders up to date in the tournament. Gretzky 3 points ahead of Lemieux. Makarov having a big night tonight, is close to within a point of Lemieux. And Krutov with 14 points now. Nicely balanced 7 goals and 7 assists.
Here's Messier to, or at least Gretzky to talk it. Couldn't get a stick on it. Gretzky again. Tries to center. Lemieux was open but panned on it. And the Soviets come back, led by Lomaka. 2-on-2 break. Murphy there to use the poke check. And ties up Lomaka. And Lomaka trying to freeze it. Murphy gets it loose. Larry Murphy. Fires it in. Gretzky comes in. It comes to Murphy. Back to Bork. Into Lemieux. Soviets go into that box. They drop it to Bork. A drive and a save by Milnikov. And he held it.
Big thing about this line, the way they've got it now with Lemieux and Gretzky, they've added Tocchet to the line. And Tocchet's the man. He's the designated slot man. He's in there to cause problems for Milnikov. Good play here, and this is the difference. They're getting the shot away now with Tocchet right in front of the net. Gretzky swooping in, looking for any kind of a rebound himself. He's a very important guy in this game so far, Rick Tocchet. He's played a lot of roles, but most of them are the physical roles, and he's been very much responsible for the 2 goals that Canada has. Points on both of them.
Tocchet from Scarborough, Ontario, a key member of the Philadelphia Flyers. 1:20 left in the penalty. Now Gretzky over to question the referee Koharski about something. Soviets, Ron, to me, tonight when they're shorthanded, are playing the box and not playing as aggressively in a shorthanded situation as they did earlier.
They don't want to let them get too much of that game in close.
Here's Bork for Canada. Into Lemieux. Back to Bork. Over onto the wing to Murphy. Centered. Tipped away by Makarov. Lemieux. Back of the net to Gretzky. In front to Murphy. Shoots. He scores!
Oh, play with it. Shoot it. What happened was the defense got spread out here. Tocchet, they started worrying about Tocchet at the side of the net. Murphy wound up getting the puck at the side. As the defense was going the wrong way on the short side, he put it in. But whether that shot had been blocked or not, it certainly paved the way for a good rebound. And as it was, it found the hole. And Canada trails by just a goal.
Another great setup by Gretzky as Murphy gets his first of this Canada Cup. Comes with 10:40 left in the second period.
The other point goes to Mario Lemieux.
So Gretzky and Lemieux get the assist. Canada within one of the Soviets. Here's Priyakin coming in. Coffey trying to take him out. Back to get it. This Tocchet feeds it to Gretzky. Delnov in to tie him up. And now Gretzky gets it to Coffey. Out for Tocchet, but intercepted and shot back in by the Soviets. Coffey back for Canada. Coffey being checked by Priyakin, and Priyakin dumps it in. And now Prop has to go back for Canada. Out on left wing to Gretzky. Over for Hartsburg, off the boards for Prop. Brian Prop, number 26, shooting it in. One back to get it, Prop checked. Gretzky stole it, centered, Kaminsky intercepts. Soviets come back. Number 13, Kaminsky. Lets it go, and that's high off the glass. Right back the other way, Canada with Gretzky. To Coffey, to Prop, has Sutter with him. Here's the shot, high and over the glove of Milnikov. Prop behind the net, trying to get it to Sutter. Brent Sutter for Canada. Bekov comes up with it. Now to Holmatov. Holmatov got it to the line. Rochefort held it in, and Gusarov has it for the Soviets. to Homotov, number 15. Flipped in, cleared out by Crossman. Now Fedotov trying to set up Kamensky. Back comes Crossman for Canada, trying to feed it up to Goulet. Goulet on the left wing boards. Slides it around. Into the corner goes Crossman. Now to Howardchuk. Dale Howardchuk, center to shot. They score! Brent Sutter ties this game up! The key to this is look at the traffic in front of the net. Out comes the pass. Everybody going for the net, and Sutter with a great shot off the roof. Howardchuk is getting it out in front. Sutter moving in. Glove side. Couldn't put it in a better spot. Canada comes back to tie it at 4-4. The Soviets at one time led 3-0. Howardchuk and Crossman will draw assists on this. Here's Howardchuk out in front. Again, that great shot. The feeling is glove side high on Milnikov. You can beat him. He doesn't have a good glove hand. Brent Sutter's first goal of the tournament. Howardchuk and Crossman the assist. 11:06 the time. Canada 4, the Soviets 4.
Oh, the crowd's starting to take over, too. You can hear them start to build with the Murphy goal. Now they're really going. Got the coach up on top of the bench.
Wow. Something has been thrown onto the ice, and that's where why we're having the delay is one of the rink attendants comes out to straight something that's been thrown onto the ice. That gives Milnikov a chance to get a breather.
Get another look at the goal by Sutter. And again, we talk about the problem that Milnikov has with his glove hand. Howardchuk handling it from behind the net, feeds it out in front. And the slow glove. Now that's a tough shot for anybody to deal with. I don't care, but right now it's put Canada into a 4-4 tie. We'll take a break right now as they clean things up on the ice. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
It's time for Adventures of the Original Social Animal. Here we are with the Grand Poobah of Fun, Spuds McKenzie, as he's planning his jamming as tonight's main attraction. His fans watch as he turns his way to elegance. Add to this a facial and massage, and Spuds McKenzie's raring to go. That means Bud Light for everyone, as Spuds does it right with only Bud Light. Everything else is just a light.
Canada 4, the Soviets 4, and here we go with Bork flipping it in for Canada. Racing in was Sutter, but it was whistled down on an offside or a high sticking call, I believe, ruling that the Soviets had knocked the puck down with a high stick.
Canada with a 7-4 shots on goal edge in this period, but again, the shots on goal, as Dan mentioned, not a good statistic in this particular game because the Soviets have had so many good scoring, clean scoring chances. They scored 3 goals on their first 4 shots, and each of them was a good, clean scoring chance.
Now Gilmore, Lemieux, and Sutter, the Canada forward line. Breaking out is Womackin for the Soviets. Poke check by Bork and Lemieux. Right back for Canada. Mario Lemieux trying to leave it there. Knocked down and Semyonov. Right back the other way for the Soviets. Lemieux gets up limping. Now Gilmore back of the goal. Gilmore trying to clear it out, and now we're going to get a penalty. Back of the play is Lemieux and Kasatonov. We're making threatening glances at each another.
All right, here's the play. Now there's a slash in here, but watch the skate of Kasatonov. And there's the slash across the back of the leg. But I don't think Lemieux appreciated that skate very much.
been inadvertent, but it certainly was an area where it could have caused a lot of damage.
So the Soviets in this 4-4 game with a man advantage. Slashing against Lemieux. 8:26 left in the second period. Soviets are 0-for-1 with the man advantage tonight. They send out the green unit. Larionov, Makarov, and Krutov with Fetisov and Kasatonov on defense. Canada with Messier and Gartner up front. Soviets with the man advantage. Rospor from the faceoff. Tries to clear it out, pinching in Fetisov to Larionov. Larionov to Makarov, kicks it to Krutov, and Rospor checks in. Kasatonov held it in. Over onto the board to Larionov. Back to Kasatonov, return to Larionov. Now to Fetisov, shooting, blocked by Gartner. Fetisov to Krutov, and Gartner breaks it up again. And then cleared at the center up. Couple of key plays defensively by Mike Gartner. Here's Krutov. To Fetisov. Now to Larionov. Larionov flips it in. Krutov cuts in. Big save, pure rebound. And that's chopped away by Crossman for Canada. Larionov held it in. His shot blocked by Messier, and Rossmore shoots it away. And a minute left in the penalty, and a interference call as Gartner gets upended, and an interference call coming up here to the Soviets and to Larionov.
Watch the left-hand side of the screen on the replay, and you'll see Gartner, number 12 for Canada, knocked down right in the center ice zone as the puck was cleared up ice. Larionov. That means that Canada, at the end of the Lemieux penalty, will have a minute and 2 seconds, barring further penalties. They'll have a minute and 2 seconds of power play. Here's Krutov. Every time you see these guys, you got to get up on the edge of your seat. What a save that was. And then Kasatonov moving quickly in for the rebound, but he was forced into the corner.
Krutov scored a goal in game two in a very similar situation.
Each team a man short, copied down.
Anderson deflected it. Milnikov made the save and then smothers it. 53 seconds left in Lemieux's penalty. 1:56 left in Larionov's penalty for the Soviets.
What a deflection there by Anderson, taking that shot from the point by Coffey, and it, all he did was get the heel of the stick on it and steer it right into the padding of Milnikov.
Gretzky getting Coffey positioned properly. Gretzky against Bekov on the faceoff. Gretzky gets it into the corner. Gets help from Anderson. Now Stelnov over. And he gets help from Bekov, who feeds it off to Homotov, number 15. Coffey spun him around. Goharski looks the other way as he figures Homotov took a dive. And it's Hartsburg shooting it in.
And he did.
To get it, number 29, Igor Kropchuk, out to Bekov. Bekov trying to get around Hartsburg. Bekov to Homotov. And Canada come back. Here's Gretzky. Gretzky trying to get Coffey going the other way. Now a break for the Soviets. 2-on-1. Bekov to Humalap, and a stick save by Buehr. On the 2-on-1, now Lemieux back on. Another shot by the Soviets. Buehr the save, and here's Lemieux with Gretzky. 2-on-1 break. Big save, Milnikov on Gretzky. And that time it was Lemieux putting in number 99, and Milnikov slid across to make the save. Canada on a power play. 35 seconds left in the Soviets' penalty. Now Semyonov firing it in. To get it is Bork for Canada. Ramo Bork flips it in. Fetisov back after it. That's Coffey it into forecheck. Here's Gretzky. Centered, Lemieux in front, couldn't get the shot off. Gretzky again. DeBoer. Over to Murphy. Into Gretzky, back to DeBoer. Into Lemieux. Across to Murphy. Shooting! Blocked at the defense on a dive across by Fetisov.
Oh, they moved it around again and around and around, and they did set up a play. But a defenseman was the one who took the shot. Fetisov making the save on Murphy. Very nicely set up. There's Rick talking. Big check inside the zone started this. That's Lemieux. Across. Here's Murphy. And the shot blocked by Fetisov, who was down with plenty of time to block that shot. Could have been a Gretzky or a Lemieux. You might have seen a quicker trigger. Now Larionov
is out of the penalty box, so the Soviets are at full strength. 5:23 left in the second period. Canada 4, Soviets 4. Here's Messier on a faceoff. Gets it to Gartner. He and Fetisov battle. And now Krutov to Makarov. Back to Krutov. Upended, and Crossman is there for Canada. Trying to clear it up. Makarov held it in. Over to Kasatonov. His shot blocked. Messier couldn't get it up. Here's Makarov. Back on the point to Fetisov. Centers to Krutov. Shot right on, and Fuhr made the save and held on. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Ladies and gentlemen, a reminder
that... Hi, I'm Daphne Little.
And I'm Bob Tillman.
Just like Canada Cup begins the hockey season, here at 2-3 TV, we've got great new shows beginning our season, too. For example, Thursday at 9:30, there's Night Court.
And at 10 on Thursday, there's the big city police action of Night Heat.
And then Friday at 8 o'clock, it's the hour-long debut of Family Ties.
It's another great season of TV viewing starting this week on 2-3 TV.
In this game, here is one of them. This is the one we mentioned. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Greg Louganis.
On the top was the player who Koharski just looked at him and looked the other way.
I'll tell you something, both sides are doing a fair amount of that tonight.
Soviets, Fetisov at the point for the faceoff. Closing in, Murphy dives to poke it away. Now Makarov, back of the net, gets it back from Fetisov. Makarov for Krutov. He's checked, Canada clear it. Soviets hold it in, but now carried up by Murphy. As Howard Chuck and Sutter with him. To Howard Chuck, shoots. Yilnikov the save. Howard Chuck back of the net, stuffs it in front, shoots, he scores! Dale Howard Chuck!
There's an old line, Dan, that says when you hit a guy, you create a turnover. Sutter behind the net was the reason for this play. Here comes the puck into the zone. The shot is going to go off the goaltender, Milnikov. Here comes Sutter. He's going to take the puck away. Creates the turnover. Howardchuk, one chance. Comes back out to him. Second shot into the net. And Canada, for the first time, has the lead. His fourth goal of the tournament. Dale Howardchuk. But the key again was the slugging along the board. It's almost like we're watching that big Soviet game in 1984. The sluggers are doing the job at the key time. Talkin, Sutter. Take a look at the names that are cropping up on the score sheet here tonight. Look at the turnover. Here it comes. There's the big check. And the puck is turned over.
The scoring play, Howardchuk from Murphy and Krop, 15:32 the time.
Sutter does not get a point, but I'll tell you, that guy right there loves him.
Dale Howardchuk from the Winnipeg Jets has just given Canada the lead for the first time tonight.
Isn't it amazing? We've seen so much of Lemieux and Gretzky, and suddenly in a big game like this one, the Grinders are out.
Now a Team Canada line of Gilmore, Tockett, and Goulet. 4:28 left in the second period. 5-4 Canada.
Isn't it amazing the difference in this hockey game compared to games one and two of this series? The artistry isn't there. The excitement certainly is.
And a lot of thumping in this game, more than in games one and two. Bork back after to get the puck for Canada. Passing it to Murphy. Murphy to Gilmore. Too far for him. Gilmore racing in. Got her out of the boards. Here's Tockett. Back of the net. But intercepted by Kravchuk and cleared. And the Soviets work it to Homotov at center ice. Bork took him out of the play. And Gilmore knocked it to Goulet. And now a high sticking penalty coming up to Bork as he took Homotov out of the play. And Canada will be shorthanded as Bork goes to the penalty box.
Alan Eagleson is going to be our guest during the second intermission if he can get his nerves settled down. Oh, that's an NHL referee there you're yelling at, Al. Ron Koharski calling him as he sees him, and he has seen Ray Bork high stick somebody. And he has called him for it. I wouldn't change a thing the way Team Canada is playing right now. They're getting the odd penalty, but they're also playing the type of hockey that when things have gone sour in the overall playmaking of Gretzky and Lemieux is going to win for them.
Soviets on a power play with a forward line of Semyonov, Lomakin, and Samak. White men will be Gusarov and Fedotov. Canada with Gilmore up to win the faceoff. He and Anderson are the penalty killers with Crossman and Rochefort on defense. Gilmore broke the play up. Now Gusarov dropping it back to Fedotov. To Gusarov. Alexei Gusarov up the middle for Semyonov, number 30. Samak centered and Anderson there to tip it away. And then Gilmore cleared it away for Canada. The Dotov, number 14 for the Soviets, a minute 30 left in Canada's penalty. Now Gusarov to Fedotov. Back to Gusarov. Firing to Semyonov, into Lomakin, dropped it to Samak, but Gartner intercepts. And Gartner fires it away.
Notice how they're picking up the men right at the line. Something Brad brought up. They're letting the defense back in. They're not doing it anymore.
Here's Larionov as the Soviets change on the fly, leaving it for Gusarov. Now to Makarov. Gartner checked him. Makarov tries again to Krutov. Krutov leaving it for Larionov. He drops it back, and Fetisov couldn't hold it in. 42 seconds left in the penalty. Fetisov to Kasatonov. Kasatonov, number 7. Leaving it for Krutov over to Makarov. Now to Fetisov. Into Larionov. To Fetisov to Kasatonov. Moves in deeper. And Murphy took it away from him. And Murphy clears it out of there. 12 seconds left in the penalty. One penalty killing here by Canada. Larionov now trying. Leaves it for Fetisov. Fetisov flipping it in. Rossman there to poke it away. Gretzky flips it. Anderson able to carry it out. And Gretzky now takes a pass at center ice. Breaking in with Bork. Gretzky shoots one. And that one off a stick high and wide. And back the other way, Makarov. Teams at full strength now as Bork has served his penalty. Here's Brian Propp. Fans on it as he went to clear it. Now drops it to Rochefort. Over to Crossman. Off the boards to Gretzky. Gretzky dumps it in. But Tisov there for the Soviets. Now cleared out of there by Semyonov. And Kumalev puts it ahead for Priyakin. He gets knocked down by Bork. And Bork will get another penalty here. With 1:09 left in the period. A hooking call against Bork.
Well, the bad player of the game for the Soviet Union will receive a set of 10 Olympic coins, compliments of Canadian Tire, an official supplier to the Calgary 1988 Olympic Winter Games, and a few dreams along the way. Canadian Tire.
Mario Lemieux arguing about the penalty call, but it's a hooking penalty against Bork.
Well, Ray Bork up against the boards. In this case, I'd give the penalty. They may have put a little mustard on it, but he also got hooked. Last time, Bork was off. No shots on goal by the Soviets, so they did a terrific job on the penalty killing last time out, but you can play with fire, too. You ought to keep doing this.
Just 1:09 left in the period, so Canada will, if they can get through this first part, the first 1:09, will have a break in the intermission to rest up their penalty killers. Soviets are 0-for-3 tonight with the man advantage.
And the penalty killers, who did a pretty good job last time for the most part. Gardner out there. And Rochefort will be back at the blue line.
Doug Gilmour is going to take the faceoff against Bekov,
who's shown us some pretty good skills in terms of faceoffs this tournament.
Soviets have 4 men inside the blue line. Homotov is away off on the right wing boards, but Gilmour wins the draw, and the Soviets have to go back and regroup. Here, Kravchuk, number 29, giving it to number 15, Homotov. We're in the final minute of period one. Kamienski moving in. Gardner takes him out. Fuhr out of the net to clear it. Homotov losing it. Gilmour trying to knock it out of there and did with a volleyball type move, hitting it with his hand, and he hit it up into the Soviets bench. So the faceoff will be back inside the blue line.
Off the Soviet player's head, I think. And so the faceoff will come back inside the Team Canada zone. There's Doug Gilmour. There's some of the players that have really noticeably improved their game as the finals have come on. Gilmour and Brian Propp is very interesting. The overtime period the other night and this game, playing very, very well.
Now Messier comes out to replace Gardner, so Messier and Gilmour will be the penalty killers. Now Gardner comes back. And they're going to take Gilmour out of there and leave Gardner and Messier up front.
This is a Team Canada home game, by the way. They have the last change, or whatever it's worth.
Back up against Messier. 47 seconds left in the period. Soviets on a power play. And they get it to Stelnov, who moves in from the point. Shot it around, Homotov. Trying to center one, Gardner there to clear it away. Kravchuk, number 29, back to pick it up. Kravchuk was supposed to be out for this series with a knee ligament problem, but he's in there tonight. He feeds it to Kamienski. Into Homotov. Rockport ties him up, Homotov gets loose. Gardner hacks away on it. Now back off to Kravchuk. Shot right on. Kamienski after the rebound. Kravchuk a drive, and that's just wide. And Messier with 8 seconds left clears it out of there. Soviets have to go back. Kravchuk with 2 seconds left clears it up. Second period is over. A good one for Canada as they come off the ropes and take the lead after 40 minutes.
Well, they outscored the Soviets in the second period 3-0. And they have the lead 5-4. Canada outshot the Soviets 12. The Soviets outshot Canada, correction, 12-8 in the second period. Just the turnaround of the last period. Canada outscored the Soviets 3-0.
We've seen that a time or two before in this series. 5-4, Canada leads after two. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Test drive of a Volkswagen Jetta can lead to a flight on the British Airways Concorde to Europe to pick up your prize of a brand new Jetta.
See your Volkswagen dealer and join the Jetta Set.
When it comes to autofocus cameras, some give you part of the action, but Canon EOS gives you all of the action. When the lights are so low that some autofocus cameras can't focus, EOS doesn't miss a trick. And Canon EOS has computers and motors in every lens for fast focus. So great shots are easy, and so creative, the competition is out of the picture. Canon EOS, more than autofocus, easier than ever.
Perfect day for it. 50
years ago, Air Canada started out with one small plane and one huge country. The obstacles that faced our pioneers were as imposing as the land itself. But the demands of the country stretched our knowledge, our wings, and our imagination. Today, Air Canada has earned its reputation as a world-class airline. But that hasn't made us complacent. We'll still be reaching for the moon and the stars tomorrow. And we invite all Canadians of vision to join us.
The Soviets took a 4-2 lead into the second period. They will take a one-goal deficit into the final frame. Big night so far for defenseman Larry Murphy. He's got his first goal of the tournament and a couple of assists, and it's been the Grinders and the Bangers, the Sutters, the Howardchucks, the Tockets, who have really made the difference so far in this hockey game. Canada coming back with three goals, unanswered goals in that second period. Now let's go upstairs to Ron Reusch. He has a special guest.
Very special guest, Dan. Red Fisher of the Montreal Gazette, who's been watching world hockey for a long, long time and has been just as excited as all of us over what has been transpiring here at this Canada Cup.
Well, it has been exciting. Certainly, the first two games, this game right here, it's 3-0, 8 minutes into the first period. Good heavens, we're all burying Team Canada again, and I include myself in the group, and then suddenly here they come back, and it's 5-4, and this game is not over, Ron. We know that. Everybody out there knows that. It's just been a remarkable series thus far.
Red, you were with it all the way in 1972, so really you're from the beginning, you've been watching this sort of thing unfold. We asked this question all over. We've been asking it in corridors and so on. You watched Game 8 back in 1972 in Moscow, and you watched these two. Compare them.
Well, 72, because it was the first, Ron, more emotional. This thing, more exciting, I find. You know, the comebacks, one after another, three games in a row, three comebacks. But emotion won it all in 1972, and I still lean to 72 because of that, but I'll take this anytime. It's just been just great.
I remember back in 1969, we were all at the World Tournament in Stockholm, Sweden, yeah. And you saw some Soviets that year. I remember talking to you during an intermission over there at that particular time, and we asked the question at the time, are there any of these guys that could play in the NHL? You at that time picked out a couple, but it was only a couple.
Well, actually, there were three, Ron. As a matter of fact, it was an answer later on to a question by Sam Pollock, who was always looking for an edge. When I got back to Canada, he said, can any of these guys play in the National Hockey League? I said, three, Sam. A guy named Karlamov, a guy named Yakushev, and a fellow named Maltsev. And I think as things turned out, it wasn't a bad job of scouting. But, of course, Sam didn't go after him, and that's his problem.
This game tonight, it's much different from the first two games of this series. I think a little less artistry, a little more banging.
Well, they're certainly banging all right, and for a while I was afraid it was going to get a little bit ugly when the score was 4-2. The sticks really came up high and some people started running at each other, but I think now with the score 5-4, I think we may see a little bit more artistry in that third period. And, you know, I don't know if you want overtime. I just as soon have this thing settled in regulation time for a lot of reasons, and one of them starts with my little ticker right here.
You know, they are so close, aren't they? It's very seldom I've seen two teams go through an extended series, and this is their one, two, three, four games now, dead even like this.
Well, you know, there's one goal separating the teams after all this play, and so close. I mean, they are just stuck together. I mean, there's no difference between the two. one team is going to win on one night, the other team is going to win on another night. And you and I, as we sit here, are probably looking forward to an eight-game series in 1990. And God willing, we'll both be there. And it's just great. I mean, this international hockey is outstanding. But, you know, I think I could use a rest just about now, so I'm kind of looking forward to Hull, Quebec on Friday and the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Montreal Canadiens in an exhibition game, and let's have a little fun.
Well, it's a different kind of hockey,
that's
Red.
Right.
Thanks very much. Red Fisher of the Montreal Gazette joining us up here in the press box level. We'll be rejoining Dan Matheson in a couple of moments. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
First came Gillette's legendary Track 2 Twin Blade. Now there's Track 2 Plus. Advanced lubricants in a unique Luber Smooth Strip are released to deliver Track 2's smoothest, most comfortable shave ever. New Track 2 Plus from Gillette, the essence of shaving.
Double the knowledge!
Join us in our celebration of the very best. Join us looking to the future, showing you our pride.
At GM today, we're proud that the cars and trucks supplied for the Calgary 88 Olympic Winter Games will be built by the people of General Motors.
Searching, always searching for the best. Join us!
Hey, Canada, join us!
Join us!
Good times ain't hard. Good friends in the hot, hot sun. Oh, doesn't
if you're looking for racy lines, precise cornering, and a great stereo, Zenith's trim 29-inch designer TVs will put you in the driver's seat. Zenith. Quality.
Hi, I'm Daphne Little.
And I'm Bob Chalmick, and we're inviting you to join us Wednesday night here on 2-3 TV for a great evening.
Tomorrow night at 9 o'clock, it's the debut episode of St. Elsewhere. I mean, what happened to Dr. Auslander? And will he make it out of the building?
At 10 o'clock, A Year in the Life debuts, and we'll have a chance to see just what has happened to the family since we've seen them last.
That's tomorrow night here on 2-3 TV, beginning at 9 o'clock.
The second period was a big one for Team Canada. Three unanswered goals. Canada now leads the Soviets 5-4 with 20 minutes yet to play. So don't go away. This team can score a bunch on you in a hurry. This game is far from over. Someone who's feeling a little better now than he was after the first period, Alan Eagles, joins us now. You like a one-goal lead better than two-goal deficit?
Oh, I think so. I thought you were supposed to have a Soviet player for the interview.
Well, we were going to have a Soviet player one time.
So you
time,
got another but... Red Fisher. Wow.
You know, Ron Reusch was asking Red about, he says it's been kicked around by a lot of fans and people in the prints as well, the differences between the 72, game number 8, and this game here tonight.
Oh, well, if we win it, as I think we're going to now, I suppose you'll make that comparison. But the difference then was we were 8,000 miles from home. We had to win three games in a row on their ice, and nobody gave us a chance. And the team kept working and working and working. We lost the first game, blew a 4-1 lead, lost 5-4, and then went three in a row by one goal, with Henderson getting the winning goal in all three games. Tonight, I just can't imagine this game being this good. I thought I'd seen the best game last Friday. Then I saw the best game last Sunday. And now look at tonight. Down 3-0. Not any other team. I don't think any Canadian team would ever quit. But it's an easy reason to quit. Down 3-0 after about 8 minutes. And then
to
what do we do?
To a team that can play.
Huh. We pick. But I think the good part about it was, even though they were down 3-0, they knew that the Soviets had only had four shots to our 8 or 9. Mm-hmm. They knew we had chances, and I think they know when Gretzky's out there, Lemieux's out there, Howardchuk's out there, and on and on and on. And Murphy, the no-name players compared to Gretzky and Lemieux, they know that everybody's out there to try. And it's nice that the baggage handlers, as we call them, are carrying the freight tonight for the big boys.
Alan, let's get rid of the fan hat for a while and put organizer hat on. Has Canada Cup 87 been a success?
Tough to get the fan hat off, I'll tell you. Somebody asked me why I run the Canada Cup shirts for the pension plan. It's to get our best against their best, and this is a perfect series, Canada-Soviet Union. I want our team to win so badly. They've worked so hard, they've given everything, they've given their summers. They don't care about thousands of dollars that they could be risking in their careers. They're playing for their country. I'm doing it for my country and for my team. Sure, I'm the chairman. It's an economic success. Thanks to the people of Hamilton. Thanks to the people of Sydney, Nova Scotia, to Halifax, to St. John's, Newfoundland, to Regina, to Calgary, to all of the cities that helped this tournament be a success. From Labatt, Canada Cup, thank you very much. I just want to see the players in the third period win it for Canada. That's why they're playing.
Alan, you couldn't say it any better. Thank you very much. Alan Eagleson, he helps put this little shindig together every 3, 4, or 5 years. When's the next one?
1992.
1992
for
sure. One goal, Canada leads, but there's 20 minutes of hockey yet to come. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Sun ain't up when I start. I'm working hard, but I'm working smart. I got me a Honda to get around. I got power. A four-track to 4x4 to cover ground. And I'm a four-wheeling, good-feeling Honda four-tracks man. A four-wheeling, hard-working man. Yes, indeed.
Wouldn't it be nice if you could make your kitchen fresher and cleaner?
Fresh and clean.
Glad Kitchen Catchers can help you do just that.
Fresh and clean.
You see, Glad Kitchen Catchers have a unique odor-suppressing ingredient in every bag, working continuously to surround and suppress garbage odors. That's how Glad Kitchen Catchers help you enjoy a kitchen that feels fresher and cleaner. Glad Kitchen Catchers.
Fresh and clean.
Certainly a different period than what we saw in the first 20 minutes of play. Canada rallying to come from two behind to one in front. What have we been doing differently, Brad?
Well, definitely, I think there was a change of attitude in the dressing room and the determination started to play off. But also, some little things that really make a difference. We're going to look at the first highlight. Canada starts to move the puck and only move it when they're beating somebody. Here's Ray Bourque behind the net. Canada goes on the attack. He passes to Larry Murphy. There's one guy beaten. Now, Larry Murphy does not pass the puck here because it's not going to beat anybody. He gets to the blue line, looks for Mario Lemieux, the shovel pass to Mario because Mario had a step on the guy, and Canada is all of a sudden in the Soviet end and starting to apply pressure. Mario Lemieux out to Ray Bourque. Ray Bourque going through the middle. Keeps the puck ahead of him. Watch in front of that. Wayne Gretzky to Mario Lemieux. Can't handle the puck, but draws the penalty and gives Canada power play. And what do they do on that power play? But they get a goal. We're going to have a look right behind the net with Mario Lemieux. Now, this guy has got a big reach. He can't be knocked off the puck. Makarov is not a big player. Lemieux behind the net to Gretzky. Gretzky in his familiar position out to Larry Murphy. One-timer through two pairs of legs, and Canada is back in the game at 4-3.
Brad, you were talking about drawing penalties and power plays. This game has had a lot of penalties in it. We've seen a lot of penalties throughout the series, not because it's been a rough series, but because everyone on the ice throughout this entire series is so fast, you have to get a piece of somebody. And if you're not going the same directions they're going, you have to grab them, you have to hook them, you have to interfere. And those are the kinds of penalties we're getting.
It has. You've got the, you know, the Soviet players skate so well, and the Canadian players also. I think that this is one factor that nobody ever appreciates, because these guys are moving so fast, they don't have time to make the easy decisions. They got to make quick-thinking decisions, and sometimes you're gambling pretty good.
Sometimes the legs are going quicker than the head, too.
Yeah, but we're going to look right now. The one problem the Czechs and the Soviets have had is the problem behind the net. That is, on the goal that Murphy got, the same thing. Now here goes the wrap around. The Canadians have gone to the offense. Watch Doug Crossman make a real heads-up move here. Moves in on the far boards, keeps the puck in, and where does it go? Behind the net to Dale Hawerchuk. Dale Hawerchuk is almost as good as Wayne Gretzky. I wouldn't say quite, but what does he do? He finds Brent Sutter. Watch him get open at the top of the slot. The one-timer up over Melnikov's shoulder. A great shot. The game is tied. Behind the net just seems to work. The Soviets have trouble with it. We're going to watch Canada attack again. Here's the shot by Hawerchuk going wide. He winds up. Melnikov stays back in the net, has trouble hanging the shot. Now watch Sutter coming through, taking Kasatonov. Boom, the puck's behind the net. There's a little confusion. Dale Hawerchuk does an unbelievable job staying with it. The second shot, there it is. There's the lead. It's a lot of confusion behind that net.
Big period for Hawerchuk. He set up the tying goal, scored the go-ahead goal. I guess we're more comfortable being up one, are we, than being down one?
I don't trust that team we're playing against, believe me. The one thing, you know, Howardchuk got injured that period, and he's going to be an awful sore man, but he came back and got a goal, set up one. I mean, you just can't believe how well he's playing.
Doug Gilmore was in here after the first period when they were down by two. He said we have to go a shift at a time, a period at a time. We're not looking that far ahead. What do you think Canada is going to come out thinking in this third period?
Well, I don't think one goal is going to be enough to contain the Soviets. They have to think that they've got to go out and attack, but they've got to do it smartly. They can't make bad decisions. The defenseman, if the opening's there, has got to move up, make it a four-man attack, because you know the Soviets are going to do it to Canada.
Canada's up by one after 40 minutes of play, but with 20 left, a one-goal lead is rather slim. Don't go away. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Hello? You want research? Oh, no, no problem. We work around the clock here. Hold on a second. Research here. All trends are up. You're most welcome. Oops. Hello? Need a shipping date? Yeah. Oh, hold on a second. Yo, price change? Let me switch you.
The new IBM Personal System 2.
Shipping. Yeah, it'll be out in 10 days.
The next generation of power, speed, and graphics.
The price on that... the price is $89.99, effective Friday.
To help a company,
no problem,
a department, or a person get their work done.
Nice work, everybody.
Introducing the new Personal System 2 family from IBM.
Our Toyota scoring summary brought to you by Toyota, makers of the racy Celica GTS. Who could ask for anything more? Who could ask for a better second period than Team Canada played? Murphy at 9:20, Sutter to tie it at 11:06, and Howardchuk to give Canada the lead for the first time in the game at 15:32. Shots on goal favoring Canada by a wide margin after two periods, 31-17. But still only a one-goal differential.
And the Soviet Union are going to play the first 52 seconds of the third period with a manpower advantage. Just doing some quick calculation here in the broadcast area. We played 255 minutes and 40 seconds. That's four full games plus 15 minutes and 40 seconds. And the score is 19-18. You can't get much closer than that between these two teams. A lot of offense, but not much to be said between the two teams.
3-3 in the round-robin meeting, and 6-5 for the Soviets in game one. 6-5 for Canada in game two. And here after 40 minutes, 5-4 for Team Canada. Canada returning to the ice to another rousing ovation here in Hamilton.
Well, the fans here in the city of Hamilton have been tremendous. Two games here in this final. They've been behind Team Canada when they've been down. They've cheered them on in their comeback.
Canada the other night had only three lines. Mike Keenan said the crowd is our fourth line.
I'd say that's a pretty good fourth line. By the way, speaking of lines, a statistic just handed us, Mike Keenan used 22 different line combinations.
Well, we've only played two periods.
Yeah, that's right. He's got a chance yet to find seven or eight more. 29 was his figure the other night. He was in that little room of his off the dressing room, I'm sure trying to concoct a couple of others that will be right for certain situations.
First 52 seconds of this period will be pivotal because Canada and Ray Bourque will be in the penalty box as the Soviets in this rubber game, the third and deciding game for the 1987 edition of the Canada Cup, starts to unfold in period three before us.
There's something said up here after the first period. He said if it had been anybody but Grant Fuhr, he likely would have been taken out of the game. And I think probably they're right. Grant Fuhr is the kind of goaltender who can be cold in a segment of a game and then suddenly just be brilliant. And I thought he made a couple of very, very important stops in the second period. He did not have a good first period. You'll be the first to admit it. Ray Bourque in the penalty box. Off for hooking at 18:51 of that second period. The shots on goal overall, Canada 27, the Soviets 21.
So
So not as big a differential as we talked about earlier, 27-21 in favor of Canada.
That's because the Soviets outshot Canada 12-8 while being outscored 3-0.
Here we go at the third period. Hold on to your hat. Canada clear it out as Crossman shot it up on the boards, and it goes over the glass into the penalty box area.
Nearly decapitated Bork sitting there.
Faceoff will be about 10 feet inside the Team Canada blue line. Messier and Gertner up front, Rochefort and Crossman on defense. The green unit for the Soviets. Krutov, Makarov, and Larionov up front. Fetisov and Kasatonov, the point men.
How'd you like the job, Dan, of selecting the outstanding player for Canada in this game?
Or in this tournament. Puck cleared down the ice. Kasatonov back to pick it up. Soviets with the man advantage. Up the middle to Krutov, now to Larionov. Leaves for Makarov. Makarov poke checked by Crossman, and then Gertner got it to the line but not out. Now Messier does knock it out of there. And Kasatonov with 20 seconds left in the penalty. Over to Larionov. Leaving for Kasatonov. Crossman picks it off and cleared it out. Fetisov to Larionov. 5 seconds left in the penalty. Larionov firing it around. Now Bork is back on. Here's Fetisov, and a poor pass has to be covered up on by Kasatonov, who gives it to Larionov. Larionov to Makarov. He cuts in. Now around Copps. Got it in front. Fewer of the save. Still loose. Back at it. Just wide of the net. And Gretzky is back to get it for Canada. Look at Gretzky carry out. Hook check by Krutov. Covering up on the play is Murphy. Murphy into Lemieux, offside at the Soviet blue line. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
This is what it's like to be a fan in Hamilton, cheering Team Canada onto what they hope will be a victory.
Howard, Chuck, Goulet, and Tocchet for Canada. Bork and Murphy on defense. Dumped in by Canada. Howard, Chuck into the corner. Gets help from Tocchet to Howard, Chuck to Goulet, but he couldn't handle a pass. And back comes Kolmatov, number 15, with Bekov. And it's broken up by Murphy and cleared away. Number 29, Igor Kropchuk, back after it. He quickly fired it up. Goulet carried back in with a couple of teammates already in the Soviet zone, and it's called in an offside.
Now, Michel Goulet of the Quebec Nordiques, assistant 50-goal scorer in the National Hockey League. And he'll be out there playing on a line with Gilmore and Sutter. Time, and now they call him off. We're going to try a new combination that has Howard Chuck out there.
Semyonov on the faceoff against Sutter. Canada taking it. Now Murphy carries it. Firing it in. Gusarov back to get it. The same act, number 18. He just tipped it ahead to Semyonov. Howard Chuck checked him. And Murphy firing it across to Bork. Bork for Canada, dumping it in. Fedotov there with Howard Chuck into check. Now Samak back together. Tocchet ran into Gusarov and knocked him for a loop. Soviets clear it out of there. Trying to rule if Canada could have played it. There's no icing. Bork back after it. Bork to Gretzky. Leaving it for Bork. Up to Tocchet, into center ice to Brent Sutter, who fired it in. Novikov making a save, and Gusarov back to get him. Leaves it there. Fetisov loses to Lemieux to Gretzky. Here's Gretzky. A out in front, backhander, that hit Lemieux. Prop after the puck, now Gretzky. Centered, here's Coffey in and goal! Bill McCon robs Coffey! On another great setup by Gretzky. Back comes Perbukin, or Priyakin it is. His shot, the stick save by Pure. Mario Lemieux cleared it, not out. But then Coffey picks it up as Gretzky and Lemieux rhythm. Leaving for Gretzky. Gretzky across to Murphy, shot it just wide. As Murphy came in aggressively from the point. Now it's Hartsburg into Brian Brock. Up high off the glass to Zentrov. Canada changing on the fly. Here's a clearing pass to Gretzky, and they whistle that down on offside at the Soviet blue line. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Since their beginning in 1924, each Olympic Winter Games has had its memories and triumphs preserved through the creation of Winter Games posters. As an original sponsor of Calgary 88, Labatt's is proud to bring you reproductions of all 15 Olympic Winter Games posters, plus a Labatt's commemorative on cans of Labatt's Blue. So collect all 16, because even when they're empty, they're full of Olympic memories.
Team Canada seeming to play with a lot more confidence here in the third period, more in control of things, but that's the kind of thing that happens. There's a great play to copy from Gretzky, and a pretty good play by the goaltender. Melnikov stuck right with him.
Sergei Melnikov, his team trailing 5-4, and he may have held them in there with that save. Puck shot in by Canada. Anderson in on the boards, comes to the point, into the corner to Gartner. Gartner trying to get it to Anderson. Knocked away by Krawczuk, and he carries to center. Igor Krawczuk, number 29. Cuts in, shot blocked, rebound, Krutov put it over top of the net. Here's Anderson, he loses to Makarov, center to Larionov. Rossmore blocked the shot, and the rebound is poked wide. Grossman for Canada. Krutov standing right in front of the net, keeping an eye on him, but Crossman beats Gartner, and Gartner slides the puck into the Soviet zone. Delnov, number 4, back together. They head to Larionov, into Kamensky, but broken up by Bork and shot to center, and Patrick tips it into the Soviet zone. Husarov back after it. Cleared it, knocked down by Murphy. And now the Soviets. With Fedota, Gilmore checked in. Gilmore giving it to Patrick. Now ahead to Goulet. Goulet against Kasatonov, and he whips the shot high. Up into the crowd.
Four minutes, 53 seconds gone. There's Valery Kamensky. He was great at rendezvous. He scored only 13 goals in 37 games in the Soviet Union last year. But he made his year in Quebec City in the second game of rendezvous when he scored those very two important goals, and then that great goal to tie up the game the other night against Team Canada, sent it into overtime. He has just been a phenomenal player. Keep saying he's not strong enough, but he's got the great shot. As a matter of fact, I asked Grant Fuhr who the toughest shot to deal with on this team. He says Kamensky. Well, his teammates say that Krutov's got the quickest release, the most dangerous shot, says Fuhr, is Kamensky.
Here are the Soviets. Semyonov, number 30, breaking down. Semyonov is checked, and Hartsburg chops the puck out of there. Soviets go back and get it. Kasatonov, number 7. To Lomakin. He leaves it. Gusarov to Samak. Now to Lomakin. Leaving it for Samak, right through his skates, and Rick Tocchet comes back for Canada. Tocchet jumping it in. It's all the way back out to center. Hartsburg waits for his team to get onside and drills it back in. Semyonov, number 30 for the Soviets. Gretzky into forecheck, gives it to Fetisov. Now to Kumalev, number 8. Gretzky checked into Lemieux. Lemieux over to Bork, who pinches in. Back of the net to Gretzky. Back to Bork, and Ryokin had it. Gretzky held it into Murphy. Into Lemieux, shoots. Big save again by Milnikov. That time on Lemieux. Dolan centered to Gretzky. Backhander shot it wide. Oh, Gretzky with a brilliant opportunity. Here's Imolat moving back. Long shot and Dewar shot back. Now Gretzky to Brian Propp. And Propp fires it in. Milnikov didn't appear to see it. Here's Gretzky in behind the net. Chopped away by Nemchinov. Held in by Anderson to Gretzky behind the goal. Looking for Lemieux. Lemieux well covered. Gretzky will come out himself. Turn, shoots. Milnikov got a stick on it. Here's Anderson. They have Lemieux tied up in knots at the side of the net. Here's Makarov. Tied up by Gretzky but gets away. Now Nemchinov, number 12. Leaves clear for Krutov. Gretzky trying to steal it. Here's Kusara firing it in. Crossman for Canada. Back he comes with Messier. Messier shoots from a bad angle. Milnikov the save. Bodies fly everywhere. And we got to stop it. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Only from Dodge. Two trucks for the price of one. Compact plus full size. It's the midsize Dodge Dakota. The fuel economy and sporty handling of a compact. The comfort, cargo space, and pulling power of a full size. Two trucks in one, plus 7115 warranty protection. Midsize Dakota from the Dodge family of Ram Tough trucks.
When the going gets tough, the tough get going.
People are always amazed at Wayne Gretzky's staying power. He just had a shift that lasted longer than 2 minutes. And yet at the tag end of it, he was still doing things. Just missed the net, and right there was Mario Lemieux. He was going to steer that in with his hand if he could have. That was up on edge. The reason Gretzky didn't get good wood on it or a good angle on it. But what a long shift he had, and yet at the end he still had the power and the stamina to make a good scoring play.
That was Gartner from the faceoff that Milnikov stopped, and Bork beats Messier. Beckhoff tying him up. Messier beating Gartner. Pass behind Goulet. Homatov starts back, got it into the zone, still has it. Homatov to Gusara. Poke check by Bork. Homatov to Kamienski. Bork takes him out. Alfior knocking it back of the net, and Murphy has it for Canada. He goes out the other way and gives it to Bork. And Bork flips it to center. Kudobin back after it. Gartner right on top of it. Gartner up checking aggressively. Here's Gusara. Now to Kudobin. In comes Howardchuk. Kudobin beats Kamienski. Now to Bekov. Messier took him up. Howardchuk getting it in. Soviets. Bekov trying to work it free, and Lomachen drops it back. Gusara under pressure as Canada coming in to try and forecheck and rush the Soviets, and it's been working. Here's Semyonov breaking up. Long shot. Fuhr a glove save on that. Clears it up for the boards. Canada with a flip pass to Sutter that hopped over his stick. Semyonov trying to come back and copy. Has it for Canada. Into center ice. Here's Sutter to Tocchet, and they whistle it down on a two-line offside pass. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Make three AGT long-distance calls, and you could win one of three Dodge Shadows from Chrysler. Complete with an AGT cellular phone and $1,000 worth of gas from Petro-Canada.
Three-call windfall.
Or you could win long-distance gift certificates from AGT. Look for the entry form with your phone bill and enter now.
Three-call windfall.
Look at the point system or situation as far as this game is concerned. The top point man is Larry Murphy. He has a goal and two assists. Tocchet with a goal and an assist. So has Propp. And so has Sutter and Howardchuk. Not the names you would expect.
Here's Coffey for Canada. Canada leading 5-4. 11 minutes, 10 seconds left in regulation time. Here's Lemieux to prop behind the net. Prop couldn't get it centered, and Kasatonov beating one out too far ahead for Humalev. Going back is Hartsburg, and they wave the icing off to the Soviet linesman. Here's Humalev into the corner. Canada come up with it, and Prop is able to chip it out of there. And Fetisov goes back, Canada making a wholesale change on the fly. Puck cleared out, here's Larionov. Larionov moving in, taken out of the play by Krutov. Makarov with the puck. He gets tied up. Now shot around on the boards. Rossman for Canada, able to scoop it out of there. And Makarov goes hustling back for the Soviets. Messier right on his tail. Two players collide. Here's Makarov to Krutov. Now Makarov into the corner. Centered, and Messier chips it into center ice. Delnov back after it for the Soviets. And Gusarov takes over, over to Larionov. Larionov flipping it into center ice. The crossman for Canada to Norman Rochefort. Now to Gartner. He just lets it go, and here comes Doug Gilmore for Canada. Leaves it for Gartner with a drive off the glass. Bork behind the net to Gartner. Gartner trying to center. Flips it into the corner for Gilmore. He and Fedotov battle for it. Soviets come up with it, and Gusarov cleared it into center ice. 9.5 minutes left in the third period. Here's Canada with Goulet putting himself offside as he carried it in behind him. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
The house is paid up. Kids are out of college. Things are fantastic.
So what's the problem?
Things are not so fantastic. A financial genius, I'm not.
Very few people are. But at New York Life, we have the resources to make the most of your resources. Specially tailored financial solutions that go well beyond life insurance. You've worked hard, and we're here to help make your plans a reality.
Thank you.
New York Life, a more thoughtful look at life.
The hardest thing in the world is to get off to a bad start and then try to get your game right. Doug Crossman has recovered beautifully after he had his early problems in this game. That's known as playing the man. And Larionov flattened on the play. Here's Canada with a line of Gilmore, Lemieux, and Goulet. Canada with a 5-4 lead. 9:20 left in regulation time. That's off for the Soviets. To the line, but Bork breaks it up to Lemieux. Lemieux to Gilmore. Gilmore flipping it through. Fetisov back to get it. Now Fetisov can't get away from Lemieux. Here's Bekov trying. Stick handling neatly. Bekov moving it in. Broken up at the defense, and Goulet clears to Lemieux. Lemieux couldn't get around Fetisov. And now covering up for Canada, Bork to Goulet. Into Lemieux. Lemieux cutting in. Shoots one. Off the skate and just wide. Goulet to Lemieux. Lemieux back to Goulet. Goulet put it through the crease. Here's Lemieux. To Goulet. Sutter alone in front, but he couldn't get it to him. Now Sutter comes in. Canada force a face-off in the Soviet zone. 8:32 left in regulation time. Now to Chef Goulet in deep forechecking. And Canada produced a flurry around the net. The game is being played for a good part down on the Soviet end. So the old adage, a good defense is a good offense. Canada again, I can't stress how confidently Canada is playing here in the third period. They have outshot the Soviets here in the third period, 10-4. Now, Kravchuk and Sutter from the faceoff tie each other up. And we'll get another faceoff deep in the Soviet zone. Brent Sutter in this game has a goal and an assist. By the way, if you're Gretzky Lemieux fans, each has a point, each an assist. They've not been as dominant in this game on the score sheet, although they've certainly had their opportunities and have handled the puck a lot.
Both Gretzky and Lemieux have missed great chances here in this third period. Here's Tockett knocking it off the board. Semyonov checked by Sutter. He kicks it back to Coffey, who cleared it to center. Now Lomakis. He's bumped off the puck by Howardchuk. Pocket to Howard Chuck, who fires it in. Pocket. Tipping it into Sutter. Sutter and Semyonov battle for it. Look at Pocket grind behind the net to Sutter. Trying to get it in front. Lomakin is there. Now to Semyonov, number 30. Over to Samak. Moving in. Trying to get it to Lomakin. Howard Chuck had him tied up. Now center to shot. They score! Samak ties this game up with 7:39 left in regulation time.
So what else is new? Samak getting a puck right in front of the net. Semyonov being tied up by Coffey, and they kind of a collision there as Howard Chuck went with him. And the puck just rolled past Fjord. Samak closing in tight. Puck bouncing off the boards. Everybody giving chase, and a little pick allows the forward to scoot behind the net and slip it back out in front. And Samak has scored. He was the one who scored the game winner in overtime in game one of this series. So here we are, 7:39 left in regulation time, a 5-5 tie.
Here is Gartner dropping it to Rossport, to Crossman. Back for Rossport. Into center ice off of Anderson's skate. Now Anderson shooting it in. And Fedotov goes back to pick it up. Fedotov trying to clear it. Anderson held it in. Demessier got away by the Soviets. And here comes number 8, Yuri Humalek. Moving in, trying to go around Rossport. Humalek into the corner. Messier for Canada. Out to Mike Gartner. Gartner checked by Fedotov, gets it again, but then the play is offside at the Soviet blue line. 7:03 left in regulation. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Running has changed dramatically over the last 10 years, mainly because of what you put on your feet. Now, what science and technology have done for the running shoe, Mega does for the hockey skate. Mega, the first skate bioengineered to work with the foot, providing greater flexibility and faster power transfer. Mega, proven and preferred by hockey superstar Raymond Bork. Catch up with hockey's breakaway innovation, Mega, at your nearest Micron Mega dealer.
Welcome back to the Copps Coliseum in Hamilton. 7:03 left in regulation time. 5-5, Canada and the Soviets. Canada dumping it in, but Tisov back to get it. Tocca knocked him down, but he moved it to Larionov, and here come the Soviets. 3-on-3 break to Makarov. Makarov cutting in. Makarov right in, backhander wide. And Gilmore quickly moves it to Sutter. Sutter to center ice, to Tocca, but Tisov knocks it down. But Tisov in across the line, tipped back out by Sutter. And Canada with Tocket clearing down the ice. Here's number 2, Fetisov. Flipping it up, Murphy knocks it down to Gretzky. Gretzky cutting in. Jack Lemieux held it in, but now Bekov back for the Soviets. Ahead to Kamienski. Kamienski trying to cut through. Hartsburg tied him up. Now Bekov behind the net. Gretzky has him in tow, and Lemieux comes up with it. Out to Gretzky. Gretzky with Kropp and Coffey to center. Pass to Coffey. Breaking in. Coffey couldn't get around the defenseman. Delnov and the Soviets clear it out of there. Fjord lets it go for Hartsburg to touch. That's icing. 5:45 left in regulation. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Come on, Canada. Whoa, hi, I'm Terry Lynn Meyer. The Canada Cup is an exciting way to start off the hockey season. But you know, there's another new season that's just as exciting, and that's the new fall schedule on 2-3 TV. I personally love the Donahue Show each morning at 10 a.m. Monday through Friday, and then they put me to work immediately following at 11 a.m. on the Day by Day. This is 2 hours you won't want to miss, so start a morning habit tomorrow at 10 a.m., and then join me, Terry Lynn Meyer, 11 a.m. for Day by Day.
Glenn Anderson, who did most of the hitting in the first period in this game, and the rest of his teammates weren't doing a heck of a lot of it. They have come along.
Gretzky, Lemieux, and Kropp for Canada. Semyonov against Gretzky on the faceoff. D'Amico says you've got to put your stick down. And Gretzky is saying Semyonov won't cooperate. Now they do drop the puck. Knocked back of a Soviet goal. Prop into the corner with Gusarov. Gusarov took him up. Now Lemieux getting it loose on the board. Lemieux centered to Gretzky. Turns, couldn't get the shot off as Semyonov had him tied up. Now Murphy at the point. Shoots, deflected by Prop and just wide. Gusarov then able to clear it. And Murphy chases back. Samak right behind him. Samak stealing it, but Bork was there to cover up. Bork for Canada, 5-12 left in regulation time. Here is Bork. Feeding it to Goulet, shot wide, Bork in to get the rebound. Back of the net to Goulet. Out in front to Lemieux, he's too well shot. And the Soviets clear it and get it to center ice. Bork back after it in a hurry. There is Nemchinov shooting it in. Bork gets it to Hartsburg to Gretzky, who deflects it in. And Lemieux gets up, and it's the fans holler about that. Kasatonov out into center ice for Kumalev, number 8. Into Priyaka. Hartsburg took him up. Coffee back for Canada. 4:28 left in regulation time. Coffee to Howardchuk. Cutting in. Howardchuk shoots off the blocker. And then hit by a high stick. And that stops play.
Well, they hit Howardchuk on the fly in full stride through center ice. The defenseman standing still on the play. And Howardchuk just barreled right in over the line. Got a good shot away. Melnikov, here he comes. This is the tag into that rush. And he just ducked past the defense. The speed does it. They fired the shot off the blocker of Melnikov.
But was not going to be there. A high stick, and the result is the faceoff will come all the way back down into the Team Canada end of the ring. 4:20 left in regulation time.
Absolute sellout here at the Copps Coliseum in Hamilton. 17,037. I think that's a little bit more than a sellout. There's the score, and we have... I mean, it had to be like this, Dan. We simply...
Well, you knew the score was going to be 6-5 for somebody.
Yeah, that's right.
And the time in the bottom left-hand corner, 4:18 left in regulation play. Here's Rochefort to Messier, to Anderson, gets it to center. Anderson to Gartner. Gartner cutting in, but offside on the far side was Gartner. And the faceoff will be at the Soviet line.
Most of what you're seeing out there now, unpenalized, is the restraining type fouls. And I don't think that Don Koharski, being an NHL official, is going to call too much of that stuff. That would be something pretty gross and indecent for him to make a call now.
Here's Messier to Gartner, Crosspin firing it in. Milnikov back to get it. Cleared it off onto the wing. Soviets clear it out, and here's Krutov. Soviets with Krutov cutting in on the left side. Tied up, now centered, man wide open, but elected to pass, and that allowed Crossman to recover and clear it out of there. Milnikov out of the net to feed it up to Makarov, and that's a two-line pass.
Now, Makarov is, I think, the best Soviet here tonight. He has been overshadowed somewhat by his line mate, Vladimir Krutov, but tonight he is just dancing out there. He's doing so many things, and he's very, very strong and dominant in this game. Boy, the signs in this building tonight, some of them are great.
3:41 left in regulation time. Gretzky, Prop, and Lemieux. Copy gets it to Hartsburg. Shoots from the point. Prop tried for the deflection, but it took off on him and went up into the crowd.
And because he steered it up there, the faceoff is going to be outside the blue line. I think that Viktor Tikhonov has aged a little bit in this tournament.
This week.
So have we. We're not going to get overtime again, are we, Dan?
Good chance of it.
Yeah.
3:36 left. Well, it's almost like you're playing sudden death overtime now.
That's right.
3:36 left in regulation time. Canada win the faceoff, drop it into their own zone, and Pure sets it up for Paul Coffey. Off the boards to Prop. Prop Back to Copy, tipped out, but shot right back in by Fedotov. And quickly cleared up by Canada again. Now Homotov shooting it in. Copy for Canada. Off the boards for Hartsburg. Four-man rush by Canada. Hartsburg to Prop. Shoots. Melnikov, a save. Hartsburg was going for the net, but Melnikov held onto it.
Had the right idea. Feeling is that Melnikov doesn't hold a puck very well, although he certainly did there, taking it off the shaft of his stick and then holding it in his glove. Throw it in, look for the rebound, and here's a good quick shot by Prop. Let it go. And the had the right idea with Hartsburg going for the net, but Melnikov hung on to the rebound. Brian Prop right down there next to Mario Lemieux, playing a good game tonight.
Here's Sutter with Tocchet and Howardchuk for Canada. Semyonov on the faceoff against Brent Sutter. Sutter gets the draw to Murphy. Murphy shoots, that's blocked. Split it out of there with his hand. Once Canada gets possession, then it's waved off. Murphy fires it back in. Hubalev in to get it. Sutter behind the net. Tied up by Hubalev. Look at Sutter battle. To Howardchuk. Back on the point. Bork shoots up high into the crowd. And we're down to 2:36 left in overtime or in Sutton or in regulation. I think I'm thinking of overtime.
Yeah. Seen so much of it lately. Jean Perron on the foreground, co-coach with Lars Denis, or at least Keenan, Mike Keenan. Five, 2:36 left in regulation time, and they're going to call a timeout. There you see the signal from Victor Tikhonov. He has called a timeout here. But I don't, you know, when you see Gretzky out there in the middle of a shift anyway, I don't know whether I want to make a timeout call at that particular time. Give those guys a little extra rest.
Well, he must be thinking of Makarov and Krutov and his key people.
Yeah.
But it does give some of the Team Canada aces a chance to catch their breath. 2:36 left in regulation time.
Right in the foreground there, you see Makarov now. Keenan has got something going down there. He wants to flood one side of the ice. Move everybody up one side. See what happens. Off the faceoff.
Gretzky, Lemieux, and Messier will be up front. Now at the last second, he changes his mind.
When you look at this 10 years from now and you say 6-5, 6-5, 6-5, you say, boy, those must have been pretty awful defensive games. I'd have to put it the other way and say they were terrific offensive games.
Here's Messier. He's out there with Gartner and Anderson. Soviets. Kasatonov coming up with it to Krutov. 2.5 left in regulation time. Good defensive play by Rochford to break it up. Now Fetisov in center ice. Fetisov loses to Gartner. Gartner cuts behind the net. Gets it in front. Anderson, a shot. Loose puck coming to Messier. He fired it around. Here's Anderson again, but tipped away by Kasatonov. Soviets try and clear it. Messier held it in. Now Larionov breaking up to Makarov. And Rochford is there for Canada. Takes Makarov out and Crossman takes over. Crossman flipping it up. 1:50 left in regulation time. Robchuk shoots at the center. Canada taking control with Murphy. Cross ice to Copy. Copy scooping it in. Hustling it after it is Gretzky. And the Soviet player got there first, so it's icing against Canada. 1:36 left in regulation time. And a face-off deep in Team Canada's end of the ring.
Well, now it's hold on. Gretzky will take the draw down there. And they're going to send Bekov out again. He's their top man in that department. Now you have to control it.
Howard-Chuck, Lemieux, and Gretzky, all center icemen on the ice, and it looks as though Howard-Chuck will draw the assignment against Becca. Howard-Chuck wins it in. Here's Lemieux poking at the center. Lemieux ahead to Gretzky. Has Murphy with him on a 2-on-1 to Lemieux. And on goal, he shoots, he scores! Mario Lemieux with 1:26 remaining.
Fetisov shoots it in. Murphy there to clear it. Fetisov holding it in. Shot blocked. Fetisov again. Blocked again, this time by Messier. And Messier flips it to center. 30 seconds left. Here's Kasatonov. To Fetisov, broken up by Messier. Now fired in by the Soviets. Copy back with 20 seconds left. And Canada clear it out of there. 15 seconds left. Kasatonov back to get it. To Krutov, Messier breaks it up. Messier with seven.
tournament. Came to the fore. Tockett with a goal and an assist. Murphy with a goal and two assists. Kropp with a goal and an assist. Sutter, a goal and an assist. And Hourchuck with a goal and an assist.
Team Canada
outshooting the Soviets in the third period, 15-6. They outshot them every period. In the game, 46-23, the total shots in favor of Canada. And Team Canada wins 6-5 on Mario Lemieux's 11th goal.
May we never, ever hear a word about Mario Lemieux's ability or desire again.
This is the scene in Hamilton. Momentarily, we're going to go to the ice surface. Let's try and go down there now for the final ceremonies and presentation.
We are now ready for the presentation of the players of the game. Could we please have the photographer's cooperation, please? To make the presentation of the Player of the Game awards, I would like to ask from the Canon Camera Company, Mr. Paul Mather. And the District Sales Manager for Labatt, Ontario Breweries, Mr. Jim Steele. Before we do make the presentation of these two awards, wouldn't you agree with me to salute the two teams for one of the best series ever played? Game for Team Soviet Union, who will receive a Canon EOS camera. He was tremendous throughout the series. Le joueur là-bas du match pour l'équipe soviétique recevra une caméra Canon. Number two, le numéro deux, Vyacheslav Fetisov. The player of the game for Team Canada, who will receive the complete set of 10 1988 Olympic Winter Game coins, courtesy of Canadian Tire. Le joueur là-bas du match, qui recevra un ensemble complet de monnaie olympique. Team Canada, number 10, Dale Hourchuck. To present the Canada Cup trophy, please welcome as center ice the tournament chairman, Mr. Alan Eagleson. He is joined by Dr. Gunther Zabetsky, president of the International Ice Hockey Federation, and Monsieur Pierre Desjardins, president of the Brasil Labatt du Canada. Canada Cup will be presented to the captain of Team Canada and the whole team, Wayne Gretzky.
Yeah.
for the national anthem of the winning team. Let's once again hear Mr. Michael Burgess with O Canada.
Plus full size. It's the mid-size Dodge Dakota. The fuel economy and sporty handling of a compact. The comfort, cargo space, and pulling power of a full size. Two trucks in one, plus 7115 warranty protection. Mid-size Dakota from the Dodge family of Ram Tough Trucks.
When the going gets tough, the tough get going tough.
Roads aren't tough on tires. That's why you need tires that are tough on roads. Motomaster, Canada's best-selling replacement radios. They're built tough and backed tough. Like our new Motomaster XK100 all-season radio, warranted for 100,000 kilometers. So give the roads the tires they deserve. Motomaster from Canadian Tire. Built tough and backed tough.
Performance. That's why more pros wear Bauer Supremes. Bauer's superior three-way fit means better performance. With super feet precisely aligning body weight to blade, a unique ankle support system for better control, and a superb tongue for extraordinary fit and comfort. The advanced design of Bauer Supremes. A complete fit triangle for ultimate performance.
Hi, I'm Holly Doan, late night news anchor here on 23 TV, reminding you that I'll be here later tonight with all the latest in news, weather, and of course the sports highlights. You know, we late night people are able to watch David Letterman every night right after the news, and a special treat every Saturday with It's Gary Shandling Show, right after Tommy Banks Jazz. We won't miss the debut episode this Saturday, and you shouldn't either, right here.
23 TV.
We could have had a more dramatic finish if we'd had a scriptwriter plan it from the very beginning. It's finally over. It's gone three games, all of which ended 6-5.
Mike Keenan, how satisfying is this feeling right now?
It's hard to capture the feeling right now. It was a tough battle. I have a lot of respect for the Soviet Union team. They did an absolute fabulous job throughout the tournament, and our players, you have to be particularly proud of them being able to come back from a deficit such as that against such a great team. You have to be proud of these guys and our team representing Canada.
What brought them back? What, when it was 4-2, the Soviets had got off to such a quick start, what was it that brought them back?
I think it was just composure and a sense of confidence amongst themselves. They've had that throughout the tournament. And that that composure helped them keep a stable attitude throughout the game, and as a result, we won it on some individual talent that came through for us, but the overall posture of the team was very, very calm and collected, and that was important. They didn't get down when they were down by a couple of goals.
Michael, they're not too composed now. Congratulations, thank you very much. Have some fun now. Wayne, get on in here. The captain of Team Canada, the man that won the scoring title, as he does in every international tournament he plays. Wayne, that last goal, tell us about it.
Well, you know, they've been lining up on the face-off and our end the same way the whole tournament. They'd like to tie the centerman up and jump in and get the puck, and we had the defenseman tie the winger up, and Mario jumped in. The defenseman tried to pinch and threw it up, and I came across and picked it up, and you know, myself and Mario made the play, and Mario put the puck in the net, but Larry Murphy, who played a great game, created the whole situation. He went to the net, took the defenseman, and you know, nothing against Larry, but Mario's pretty good around the net. I threw it to Mario. I knew I was going to give it to him all the way in, and you know, Mario made no mistake.
This was such a close series. Every game decided by one goal. Two of the three go to overtime. What do you felt made the difference, made this team the winner?
Well, I've said it before, and I don't mean to be, I'm not trying to be critical to their team. I'm just trying to praise Canadians that...
That'll be Glenn Anderson. You can talk to him later.
Just the Canadians since 72 have been winning on guts and pride and desire. We don't get a whole lot of time to get a system down. We've won this tournament on sheer hard work and pride. We played six games with about three and a half lines. We had a lot of injuries. Nobody complained. We had a great time throughout the whole tournament, and you know, it was just a special win. My grandmother's birthday today. Happy birthday.
Big Wayne, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
The last time we had a championship decided, Dan Kelly was in a Stanley Cup final. He was in here getting wet. This time, Dan Kelly's upstairs staying dry. How do things look to you up there, Dan?
Okay, Dan, I know the feeling. The third period scoring summary, same act for the Soviets at 12-21 to tie it. And then the game-winning goal, the series-winning goal, Mario Lemieux, his 11th of this tournament at 18:34. Shots on goal, as you see, favor Canada heavily on the night, 46-23. Guts and pride, I think Wayne Gretzky described it best. And Canada wins 6-5, wins the series, 2-1. And quite a tournament and quite a series between the Soviets and Canada.
This one not as tidy and neat a hockey game as the game, the first two games of this series. Canada had that large edge in shots, but they also made some pretty big mistakes early in the game, as if they were over-prepared mentally. They just simply were too tight. They were overpassing the puck. Things were happening that were all negative, but then things came along. They started to control the game. They started to control the board. Suddenly the Sutters and the Tockets started to control things, and in the end, Canada came back. Another dramatic, dramatic victory for Canada.
Dan Matheson, grab a towel and go back to work.
Thank you very much. You know, there have been a lot of goals scored in this series, and as Ron mentioned earlier, it's not been a defensive series, but one of the men who has been outstanding from top to bottom throughout the tournament, the goaltender, Grant Fuhr. Grant, did they cause you any special problems, the Soviets, anything that you hadn't expected throughout this series?
Not really. We got off a bit of a slow start tonight and got ourselves behind the eight ball, but the bunch of guys that we have, they all dug down deep. You dig down deep, good things happen.
Well, when it was 3-0, what does a goaltender feel like? You're down in the deciding game, 3-0.
You just hope. I mean, you try to make a couple of saves, hopefully keep the games close. If you can keep it close, you know the guys are going to score you some goals eventually.
Whoa.
Who is that?
That's Anderson again.
He's done this in the third period.
In the third period, the team played with so much confidence. It looked like they knew they had the game in the bag, coming out with that one goal lead. That's Andy again. What happened in the second intermission? The team came out with so much confidence in that final period.
Oh, we've been down before. I mean, it's not the first time we've been down two goals. So, I mean, the guys knew we could come back. It's just a matter of we had to dig deep. We played well on our end. We knew we'd get our chances on their end.
These guys shooting at you throughout this tournament, some of them can put the puck in the net pretty well. Who scared you?
Their big line plays well. I mean, they kind of have my number through the series. And except for the Soviets, the average wasn't bad, but you play the Soviets, things seem to climb a little bit.
What about the rest of the tournament? You played every minute of every game. Would you just as soon have had a game off sometime? And how do you feel right now, physically?
I'm loving it. I mean, the more I play, the better I feel. So the more games I get in, the happier I am, and things worked out.
Well, Grant and Joy, thank you very much. Congratulations. We'll be right back. Canada wins Canada Cup 87. This is Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Been all the way to the west, babe, all the way to the east, and I stand just as tall in the saddle as I do in the city streets. I know there's a game and how to play, and I know when to make a stand, and I put more in like the king of bills. I'm a genuine bud man, bud, I'm a bud man.
At Texaco, we're continually changing to serve you better. That's why many stations have car washes, others full and self-service facilities. Some even have convenience stores, but all have quality products and the clean gasoline.
Glad they didn't change that.
Today and tomorrow, expect more from Texaco.
The new front-wheel drive Hyundai Excel was designed by the same man who designed this Maserati. But they are a little different. The Excel has room for three more passengers. It's more economical, and it costs about $40,000 less. Of course, the Hyundai Excel doesn't go quite as fast as the Maserati. But in the long run, that may save you even more money. Hyundai. Cars that make sense.
The man getting everybody wet in the dressing room is Glenn Anderson, who's got a terrific aim with a bottle of champagne. Brad, of course, he's had a lot of experience over the last few years. Your final thoughts on what we've seen over the last three games?
Well, Dan, it seems that every 15 years, a script is written for Canada, and it takes two teams to write that script. The Russians were there from the start to the finish. This team here was so much character, and he poured the champagne so well. But you've got to give this guy, what this club just dug down, they came up with a big effort. You, from the coaching staff down to the players, they never quit. They always went right at the right time. They put it together.
Obviously, that's the key word, character, along with a lot of talent. Hope you had fun tonight. We certainly did. On behalf of Dan Kelly, Ron Reusch, my pal Brad Park, I'm Dan Matheson. Good night from Hamilton. Producer of Labatt Canada Cup 87 is Tom McKee. Today's game was directed by Michael Lansbury. Labatt Canada Cup 87 is a special presentation of CTV Sports, produced in association with TV Labatt, and is protected by copyright. Any use of this telecast without permission is prohibited.